from the network of the 1992 Olympic Winter Games, next, CBS Sports presents the 1991 All-Star Game.
The original Dream Game, a one-shot sideshow for the 1933 World's Fair in Chicago, and you bet the Bambino was there, and with one swing of his mighty bat, he turned it into a classic. A Midsummer Night's classic, we now call the All-Star Game.
It is gone! Home run, Cal Ripken, we're tied at three!
Ken Griffey on the run, he leaps and makes a spectacular catch!
Henderson seals third base, number 939.
Yes, sir, let's admire this one. Home run, Joe Carter.
And now it's Andre Dawson. He hits a drive. Forget all about it. Goodbye.
Dibble brings it. And a swing out of it.
What a play by Ozzie. Unbelievable.
Park hits it deep to right, and nobody's going to catch this one. It's a home run.
And how great would it be if you could pencil in Hank Aaron and Willie Mays into your lineup? Have Stan the Man Musial step up to the plate for you, or say, hey, Ted, go ahead and win it for us, and Williams did. The point is, great players provide great memories. And tonight, the great players, the All-Stars, have gathered one more time. We looked it up for you. Toronto, it's an old Indian word for meeting place. And here in Toronto, Ontario, the All-Stars are meeting to play baseball as they link our national pastime with the stadium of the future. My friends, this is SkyDome. 50,000 seats, 5 restaurants, a health club, and yes, even a hotel. Now sure, every hotel has television, most even have cable, but where else can you check into your room and check out a game? So come on in, right through the lobby. It's sort of like the song says. You can check in anytime you want, but after you see this, you may never want to leave. Because tonight, it's not just any game. It's the 1991 Major League All-Star Game. And so from our perch high atop left center field in SkyDome, poised at the end of the world's longest lounge. Hi again, everybody. I'm Pat O'Brien, and welcome one and all to this special edition of Baseball 91. First, the bad news. The baseball season is now half over, but the good news is we've still got another half to enjoy, and tonight we get to have some fun with some of the greatest players in the game and lineups that you, the fans, helped create. And so as we get right to work here, a few moments ago, both teams welcomed some very special visitors. This was the scene inside the American League clubhouse.
Hey, Harold, how are you doing?
How are you?
It's been a while. Glad to see you.
How are you?
Good to see you.
This is Ricky Henderson.
Yes, I saw Rick down in over in Baltimore a while back.
This is Dave Henderson.
Yeah.
Henderson twins. That's right.
Sorry about that.
There was some scene in there. American League President Dr. Bobby Brown escorting Canadian Prime Minister Brian Mulroney and, of course, President Bush. Also in that American League clubhouse, the first brothers to start on the same All-Star team since the DiMaggio's back in 1949. And our Tim McCarver is with the brothers Alomar. Tim?
Pat, here with the Alomar family. Sandy, you weren't that excited about playing baseball when you were younger. Why not?
Well, I thought baseball was in front of me anytime, and God gave me that talent. So I thought that at that time it was kind of boring, but I was doing a lot of dirt biking, a lot of taekwondo, and I felt more interested for that at that time.
Your feelings, Bobby, about starting with your brother in the All-Star game?
Oh, yeah, I feel real happy to play with my brother. I think so. We deserved it. We've been, you know, not only good player, we've been good person, and that's the main thing for us to be here in the All-Star game.
Julio Franco says he should start. Your thoughts on that?
Well, I thought he got a number. He should have started, but, you know, I don't vote for myself. The people vote for myself, and he had to be happy because he's here in the All-Star game, and if he want to start, I'll let him start. I just want to be here and have fun.
And Papa Alomar is here tonight, but this is the part of the family tree that these guys will be using for the American League tonight. Pat?
All right, Tim. Thank you. Papa and Mama must be very proud. They're also getting ready over in the National League clubhouse. They've dropped three straight now to the American League, and manager Lou Piniella had some words, not real strong ones, for his squad this evening.
Now, we're going to have some fun tonight, and I'm going to use as many people as I possibly can. And we might have to hold one or two pitchers back or a player or two back at most. But I know this is a game where you guys deserve to be here, and we're going to use as many people as we can. Now, it doesn't mean that we don't want to win. I got a message from the league president today. He called me in my room, and he says, look, I'm 0-2 since I've been in the league. So he says, let's get the first win. So hopefully tonight... we'll go out there and get it done.
Well, tonight, Sweet Lou has given the starting nod to help get it done to a first-time All-Star Atlanta left fielder Tom Glavin, who spoke earlier with our Jim Cott.
You get the word you're going to start the All-Star game. What kind of thoughts have been dancing through your mind since you've heard that?
Nervous excitement. I was excited just to be here and get an opportunity to be here, and I was looking forward to that. And now being the starter is just kind of icing on the cake. And a little bit more nervous now, but I'm just going to try and relax as much as I can and concentrate on having fun.
You followed Wade Boggs for quite some time growing up in the Massachusetts area. You thought about that confrontation, how you're going to handle it?
Yeah, that's going to be fun. He played a little while there in Boston. I had a chance to watch him while I was growing up before I got into playing pro ball. So I always sat there in my living room and wondered how I'd do if I pitched against him, and tonight we're going to find out.
All right, have a good time. Throw strikes.
I know what you're thinking. Sure, he may be 25, but he still doesn't look old enough somehow to be starting an All-Star game. For the American League, Tony La Russa will start Jack Morris of the Twins. The veteran right-hander right there will be making his fifth All-Star appearance and his third start. Well, folks, I have waited all week long to say this. When we come back, Ted Williams and Joe DiMaggio as a special All-Star edition of Baseball 91 rolls on from the balmy shores of Lake Ontario here on CBS.
This special All-Star edition of Baseball 91 is brought to you by Advil, advanced medicine for pain. And by America's favorites, A&W Root Beer and A&W Cream Soda. It's the taste that made A&W famous.
When your office is 200,000 acres of rugged woodland, you need a deodorant you can depend on. Men count on Old Spice to help prevent odor before it starts. It kills odor-causing bacteria on contact. 99%. That's effectiveness you can count on with the clean, classic scent of Old Spice.
Cyan tested at the office.
You bet.
Old Spice deodorant, because prevention is the ultimate form of protection. Count on it.
They were our boys of summer. The legends of the game. Players like Babe Ruth, Lou Gehrig, and Ty Cobb, now presented in never-before-seen color home movies. Movies shot by fellow players and fans. Capture the glory of the golden age of baseball. When it was a game, now playing only on HBO.
Are you brave enough?
Move it, move it!
Are you quick enough?
We came back to the car was gone.
Are you tough enough?
I also have a ticket for an outstanding summons for my husband, may he rest in peace.
You better be. You're about to be driven to extremes. An all-new 48 Hours Wednesday.
Welcome back. Of course, there are all-stars, and there are all-stars. 50 years ago, Ted Williams and Joe DiMaggio electrified baseball fans everywhere, including a fellow Hall of Famer, our own Jack Buck, who joined them last night to talk a little baseball.
I look at that swing up there of Joe DiMaggio, Ted Williams. That was some swing, some finish, wasn't it?
And I should say it was. I never saw a better right-handed hitter, and never saw a better player. All due respect, I have to say to Willie Mays, who is one of the super, super, super players.
Well, we have it on record, Joe. Ted Williams thinks you're the greatest baseball player you ever saw.
I've heard him say this before. Of course, I have to say the same thing.
But when he goes elsewhere,
the greatest hitter I've ever seen.
Yeah. Do you believe that? He's the greatest hitter you ever saw?
Yes, I've seen a few of them. Quite a few of them.
56 consecutive games and hitting safely way back in 1941. Jolton Joe DiMaggio.
Joe DiMaggio, we want you and I.
He tied the mark at 44, July the 1st, you know. Since then, he's hit a good 12 more, Jolting Joe DiMaggio.
Joe, Joe DiMaggio, we want you on our side.
Can you imagine what it would have been like, what it would be like today, trying to set that record? They'd have been in the shower with a camera with you, wouldn't they?
I believe that, too. You know, it was tough enough as it was with all the writers we had and all the radios that they had, you know, these hand radios and so forth, and get you every place they could. And the fans themselves would know where you were, and they would tip the bellboy and say, what room is he in?
Even then?
At that time, yes, mm-hmm. Absolutely. And if it had not been for Gomez, I would have gone a little batty. Gomez was a very, very big help to me. He had, you know, a great sense of humor and so forth. And he just ran the roadblock. He was very good at it.
What did you think of that streak, Ted? Well, you were watching it, and while he was hitting in 56 consecutive games, you had a batting mark of 412.
Well, you see, he had all the excitement of the summer because every day was a monumental day. Been a lot of players that hit 385, 390, even approached 400 until September. So, you know, it's always, well, let's wait and see. But towards the last, I was having a little trouble because I always think it's harder to hit in the fall. The winds are not the same. The light's not the same. Lower sun, bigger shadows.
And you had a chance to sit out that last day to make sure.
Oh, yeah, but I didn't give that a thought. I really did. I've always said there was no hesitation. I didn't even think about it. That was the last thought I'd ever had, and I didn't even have that. And I seen guys sit out to protect 300, but that was kind of cheesy.
And then you got six base hits in the doubleheader. Do you think, Joe, that Ted's 406 will ever be broken?
I don't think so myself, personally. But they'll be close. They have gotten close, but I don't believe today they will.
I doubt that his record will ever be beaten. I think that you not only have to be a super player, a super hitter, a type of hitter that Joe was. He had all the circumstances plus the greatness that he had. I don't think his record will ever be broken.
This streak is beautiful, 56 games. But I count it as a bonus. The name of the game was to win and to play for the fans that were out there watching you, Yankee fans. And we were that kind of a team. You know, we wanted to play to the fans, and I think that more ball players should give that a lot of thought, that the fan is out there to see them play, and they should do everything that's possible to keep the game going that way. Hustle is the most important thing.
1941 was not only your 406 year and your 56 in a row, but it was a 41 All-Star game. One of the biggest moments in your baseball career, Ted.
Well, it certainly was, and that, you know, I hit the home run with two men on, two men out, and we were two runs behind. But Joe had hit a ball that might have been the third out because it was a hard hit ball to second base, I recall, and he just beat the play at first base.
Claude Passot was the pitcher, and you hit it a long way in Detroit.
Did Claude Passot give you any kind of a pitch that was foreign? For instance, like a ball that might have had a little saliva on it?
No. He might have thrown it to you, but he felt that his high fastball, or his fastball coming in, and he had a little cut to it. Did he throw you any of those? A little cutting fastball, which was really, which was just like a slider, really. Not a heartbreaking slider, but just moved in on you a little bit.
Do you go to many games?
I see as many as I can. I see guys hit today that I know that's the way to pitch to them, and they're so dumb they'll do something otherwise and let them beat you.
Pitchers are dumb?
I've always thought that the pitchers were the dumbest part of a ball club. I don't have to worry about them anymore, but they don't play as often. Most of them are pitching because they couldn't do anything else. And I just don't think that they are.
They don't take
advantage. Baseballically, is smart overall.
Joe, your biggest thrill in baseball?
Being with the Yankees, pinstripes. I was not too happy about the ballpark. I would have liked to if I had to make a change to another ballpark, but I wouldn't have given it up to be just with the Yankees and being a Yankee.
He was the greatest hitter you ever saw?
No question about it.
He was the best baseball player.
Yeah.
You ever
bet he was.
You want more? So do we. And we'll hear more from the Yankee Clipper and the Splendid Splinter on Baseball 91 Sunday at 2:30 Eastern Time. We'll be back here in a moment. Stay with us.
Okie doke. Just pour it and say, wow, great tasting A&W Diet Cream Soda with a smooth, light vanilla Parker. Taste and rich, creamy diet A&W Root Beer with 100% NutraSweet. And action. Cut. All right, we all make mistakes.
Marker.
Action. Cut. Let's try it again.
Cut.
Marker.
No, my right. No. Into the glass. Cut. What do you need, glasses or are you just stupid?
I've been told both.
It's the taste that made A&W famous.
Speed. For some, it's life. Racing is in the blood. To win, all parts must work to perfection. The Motorcraft World Champions win with the same Motorcraft parts you can buy for your car. Motorcraft quality parts from Ford.
Today, a guy losing his hair can choose between being the man he wants to be.
We look great with hair. Do something to save it.
And the man he could become.
Can't you accept nature like everyone else?
Doctors have hair loss treatment programs that are proven to work. And the sooner you see a doctor, the better.
We don't want nature. We want hair.
When you've considered the arguments...
We might look great bald.
And you decide you want hair. There's only one thing to do. See your doctor. Or call this number for more information.
Some people think he's a Superman, but when a 44-year-old has to throw 75 fastballs, even Nolan Ryan's muscles can ache. So after the game, it's the medicine doctors recommend most for sprains and strains, Advil.
For me, it's a couple of Advil, and those muscle aches are long gone. And Advil's gentler on my stomach than aspirin.
Today, it isn't aspirin or Tylenol acetaminophen, it's Advil.
I feel ready to go another 9 innings.
Advil, tablets and caplets, advanced medicine for pain.
Every Sunday, around twilight, America gets so quiet, you can actually hear the sound of a single clock ticking. The time is Sunday night. The look is CBS.
Well, the postcard people might want to take these pictures and put them on a postcard somewhere and mail them all over the world, as we are right now, because this is some beautiful sight here at the SkyDome in Toronto, Ontario, and the All-Stars are getting ready to play the All-Star game tonight, and tonight it's now time to meet the Stars, and to do the honors, we turn it over to our public address announcer, Murray Eldon.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to meet your 1991 All-Stars. First, the trainers, coaches, and non-starters for the National League. The trainers, first from the Atlanta Braves, Dave Pursley. From the Philadelphia Phillies, Jeff Cooper. The batting practice staff from the Cincinnati Reds, Sam Perlazzo, Jackie Moore. Dan Williams. The coaches from the Houston Astros, Art Howe. From the Pittsburgh Pirates, Jim Leland. And now the National League non-starters from the Chicago Cubs, outfielder George Bell. The Cincinnati Reds infielder Barry Larkin. Outfielder Paul O'Neill. Pitcher Tom Browning. Pitcher Rob Dibble. From the Houston Astros, pitcher Pete Harnish. In the bullpen, catcher Craig Biggio. From the Los Angeles Dodgers, infielder Juan Samuel. Outfielder Brett Butler. First baseman Eddie Murray. Pitcher Mike Morgan. Pitcher Raymond Martinez. from the Montreal Expos, pitcher Dennis Martinez. From the New York Mets, third baseman Howard Johnson.
Keith Miller.
Pitcher Frank Viola. From the Philadelphia Phillies, first baseman John Kruk. From the Pittsburgh Pirates, pitcher John Smiley. From the St. Louis Cardinals, outfielder Felix Jose. Pitcher Lee Smith. And now, your American League trainers, coaches, and non-starters. The trainers from the Chicago White Sox, Herm Schneider. From the Toronto Blue Jays, Tommy Craig.
Well, Walter.
The batting practice staff from the Oakland Athletics, Rene Latchman. Tommy Reynolds.
Thrilled, Harney.
In the bullpen, Dave Duncan. The coaches from the Minnesota Twins, Tom Kelly. From the Toronto Blue Jays, CeeLo Gaston. Boston Red Sox pitcher Roger Clemens. Pitcher Jeff Reardon. From the California Angels, pitcher Mark Langston. Pitcher Brian Harvey. From the Chicago White Sox, infielder Ozzie Guillen. Pitcher Jack McDowell. Catcher Carlton Fisk. From the Milwaukee Brewers, infielder Paul Molitor. From the Minnesota Twins, outfielder Kirby Puckett. Pitcher Rick Aguilera. From the New York Yankees, pitcher Scott Sanderson. From the Oakland Athletics, outfielder Harold Baines. Pitcher Dennis Eckersley. From the Texas Rangers, second baseman Julio Franco. Ruben Sierra. First baseman Rafael Palmeiro. From the Toronto Blue Jays, outfielder Joe Padre. Jimmy Key. And now, your National League starting lineup, beginning with manager Lou Piniella. Batting first and playing center field from the San Diego Padres, Tony Gwynn. Batting second from the Chicago Cubs, playing second base, Ryne Sandberg. Playing first base and batting third from the San Francisco Giants, Will Clark. Batting fourth, the designated hitter from the Pittsburgh Pirates, Bobby Bonilla. Field, the fifth batter from the Chicago Cubs, Andre Dawson. Batting sixth and playing left field from the Montreal Expos, Ivan Calderon. Seventh, playing third base from the Cincinnati Reds, Chris Sabol. Batting eighth from the San Diego Padres, catcher Benito Santiago. Batting ninth from the St. Louis Cardinals, the shortstop, Ozzie Smith. The National League starting pitcher, Tom Glavine. Ladies and gentlemen, your 1991 National League All-Star team. And now, let's meet the 1991 American League All-Star team, beginning with manager Tony La Russa. Leading off and playing left field from the Oakland Athletics, Ricky Henderson. Batting second from the Boston Red Sox, third baseman Wade Boggs. Batting third from the Baltimore Orioles, shortstop Cal Ripken Jr. Batting fourth from the Detroit Tigers, first baseman Cecil Fielder. From the Kansas City Royals, the designated hitter, Danny Tartable. Batting sixth from the Oakland Athletics, right fielder, Dave Henderson.
They don't boo the Hindu.
Batting seventh from the Seattle Mariners, center fielder Ken Griffey Jr. Batting eighth from the Cleveland Indians, tonight's catcher Sandy Alomar Jr. Toronto Blue Jays, second baseman Roberto Alomar. pitcher from the Minnesota Twins, Jack Morris. Ladies and gentlemen, your 1991 American League All-Stars.
What a thrill for them and for all of us as our CBS Sports coverage of the 62nd Major League All-Star Game will continue for kids of all ages after a word from your local station.
Stephen King takes you on this summer's most shocking journey.
What is wrong with my husband?
From the Master of Mystery, Golden Years, next Tuesday.
Laurel and Hardy, Abbott and Costello. Morton and Hayes? Never heard of him? You will. Morton and Hayes premieres Wednesday, July 24th.
This is CBS.
Yo, Fab Fox, Freddy with Billy D. Williams.
Yeah.
Nothing to fly is acting in the business, but Billy, what do you do to max and relax?
Well, Freddy, I usually like to spend a quiet evening at home with a few friends and Colt 45.
Yeah, I can dig that.
Oh, yeah.
Nothing like a smooth, ice-cold Colt 45.
As a matter of fact, I have some friends waiting for me at home right now.
Billy, you sure you don't need me to come with you?
Tasting fruit juices and drinks.
Quote,
Celica, one of the most eye-catching cars of the year. Auto Magazine. The performance is stunning. Sports Car International.
Unquote. The 1991 Toyota Celica. Enough said.
Baseball memorabilia. Do you get what you pay for? The story tonight.
Welcome back to the SkyDome on this night of All-Stars. We look at Rod Carew standing next to Henry Aaron. Right now is my pleasure to send you 400 feet, that is 125 meters, to the man along with Tim McCarver who will call the game for us tonight, Jack Buck. Good evening, Jack, and I don't mean to be accusatory, but just where were you on the night of July 17th, 1941?
Believe it or not, Pat O'Brien, I was a real little kid sitting in the bleachers in the Cleveland Stadium that night doing play-by-play. My brother Earl was telling me to shut up, and we saw the Cleveland Indians, Al Smith and Jim Bagby, Ken Keltner and Lou Boudreau stop Joe DiMaggio's hitting streak that evening at 56 consecutive games. Keltner with two great plays behind third. Tim McCarver and I had the pleasure of seeing Ken Keltner up in Milwaukee a couple of weeks ago. And then Lou Boudreau made a good play on a bad hop late in the game, and poof, went the hitting streak. And I'm sure all of you good baseball fans know that that same year, 1941, Ted Williams batted 406. He is the last player in baseball history to ever hit over 400. You saw some of it at the beginning of our telecast here tonight. I had the pleasure last night of being in Washington, D.C., chatting with Ted Williams and Joe DiMaggio. We talked for 52 minutes. You saw some of it tonight. You'll see some more of it next Sunday afternoon on our CBS baseball game with California playing the Yankees. You like goosebumps? We've already had quite a few here this evening. We're going to get some more because the PA announcer here, Murray Eldon, is about to introduce the splendid splitter and the Yankee Clipper.
Ladies and gentlemen, honoring the golden anniversary of their legendary baseball accomplishments, the city of Toronto, the Blue Jays, and all of Major League Baseball salute two of the game's true immortals, Joe DiMaggio and Ted Williams. Please rise as we honor the two great nations in which Major League Baseball is played. Please welcome Canadian actor Michael Burgess, star of Les Miserables, as he sings the Star Spangled Banner. Michael is accompanied by the U.S. Marine Color Guard from Buffalo, New York.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner
to sing O Canada, award-winning singer and Toronto native Alana Miles. Alana is accompanied by the Royal Canadian Mounted Police Color Guard.
again, everybody. We're at the SkyDome. We're in Toronto. I'm Jack Buck with Tim McCarver. And Tim, these fans must be worn out already. We've already had some terrific thrills with the game yet to come.
Well, there's been excitement here in Toronto since the team expanded back in 1977. And then the SkyDome came in a couple of years ago. The All-Star game this year. The only thing they haven't had here in Toronto is the World Series, and they may have that this fall.
Yeah, they may. I'll tell you one thing we do have. Some nervous players. Tommy Glavine already said that he's a wreck, ready to start this game.
Tommy Glavine, one of 18 first-time All-Stars, and don't think they're all young either. Brett Butler, 11 years in the major leagues, his first All-Star game. Joe Carter, 9 years in the big leagues, his first All-Star game. Scott Sanderson will be 35 years old the latter part of this month. It's his first All-Star game. Exciting for everybody.
Tom Glavine, the left-hander, will start for the National League against Jack Morris of the Minnesota Twins and the American League. This place is bubbling here tonight. We'll have more fun, and the first pitch moments away.
For the past 2 years, more hardworking truck owners switched to Chevy than to any other truck. And now Chevy full-size pickup is America's best-selling truck. Number one, for one simple reason. They work.
The heartbeat of America.
Today's number one truck is Chevrolet.
Columbia Pictures presents a powerful new film.
Y'all want to see a dead body?
That will open your eyes.
Y'all got to go sometime.
And your heart.
I want to do something with my life, all right? I want to be somebody.
Roger Ebert calls Boys in the Hood a tremendously life-affirming story. A film of enormous relevance and impact.
Young brothers like yourselves, you have to think about your future.
Boys in the Hood. Rated R. Starts Friday at a theater near you.
When you were 21, we drank a toast to it.
Yeah.
We can't do that. When you were 30, you could boast of it. Now you're 40. Look at there. See? So make the most of it. Well, isn't that clever?
Yeah.
This bench gets a professional finish with Krylon spray paint.
No runs, no drips, no air. Dries to the touch in minutes.
The other brand's still tacky. Wow! What a gain!
Good gain, Mr. Uger.
Hey, she's a lot tougher than she looks.
For a fast, smooth, professional finish, get Krylon.
The race is on to make batteries that last longer. And today's Duracell batteries can even outrun the ones we made just a few years ago. Today's Duracell. You can't top the copper top.
We are accompanied tonight by the Fuji Blimp, and there's a view of some of Toronto, one of the most beautiful cities in North America. The ceremonial first pitch tonight was delivered by Ferguson Jenkins, who seven times won 20 or more. He is Canadian-born, and he'll be the first Canadian-born to enter the Hall of Fame. That will happen on July 21st. And he still throws a pretty good arm, but not that good slider low and away like he used to throw, Tim.
Slider low and away to right-handed batters. 20-game seasons that he won, primarily with the Chicago Cubs, the Texas Rangers.
And the National League will be coming up there first to bat frequently because of the dominance of pitching and because these hitters are facing a different pitcher almost every time. The games are low scoring. But, Tim, I've seen some balls fly out of this park yesterday in the home run contest and here in batting practice tonight.
Well, Cal Ripken Jr. yesterday hit 12 of 22 out of the ballpark. 12 of 22. Unbelievable.
The plate umpire tonight is Joe Brinkman. John McSherry of the National League is at first. Ken Kaiser of the American League at second. Jim Quick at third. Those are the American League umpires, and here are the National League umpires. McSherry, Jim Quick at third base, and Greg Bonet in right field. And while we're talking about umpires, we certainly give a kind thought to Steve Palermo, and his fellow umpires are dedicating this game to him as he recovers from a gunshot wound. That was tragic indeed. The starting pitcher tonight is from the Minnesota Twins, longtime of the Detroit Tigers, and Jack Morris is having a wonderful season with a mark of 11-6, and those are strange-looking shoes that he's wearing, Tim McCarver.
Wearing those shoes, they're all black for Scott Sanderson, the rookie of the Minnesota, or Scott Erickson, I beg your pardon, the rookie of the Minnesota Twins. Every time Erickson pitches, it is the day of death. He doesn't like any white showing on his socks, and Jack Morris very upset that even the white sanitary socks were showing a little bit.
So Scott is on the disabled list and can't be here, but we think of him and congratulate him on what he has done so far, and he'll be back shortly.
I'll tell you who is here backing up Jack Morris. Ricky Henderson will be the left fielder. There's Ricky. Ken Griffey Jr. from Seattle in center field. Dave Henderson in right field with the Oakland Athletics. The Boston Red Sox, one of their representatives, Wade Boggs at third. Cal Ripken Jr., the shortstop, leading the American League in hitting. Roberto Alomar at second base, one of the two brothers we interviewed earlier. Cecil Fielder, leading the American League in home runs with 21, tied with Jose Canseco. Sandy Alomar Jr. behind the plate. and Morris on the mound.
We'll see some fork balls from this pitcher. The leadoff hitter is going to be Tony Gwynn. He is leading the major leagues in hitting. He is in quest of his fifth National League batting title. Five of them. Do we have a star in our midst? And what a wonderful person, Tim.
Leading the National League with a 358 average, and that's kind of what he hits personally, too. Leading the league.
Leading the league is correct. At third base, coaching is Sam Perlazzo, one of the lieutenants of Lou Piniella. And across the way at first, it is Jackie Moore. And Lou Piniella wants to win one. Tony La Russa, the manager of the American League, has won the last two. And you heard Lou in the pregame talk to the players. He said, let's win one. And he got a call from the league president, Bill White, because the American League has won the last three All-Star games. National League still has quite an edge in the total games played. I'm wondering if Tony's going to take the first pitch, because he knows that Moore is going to try to get ahead, and he doesn't want to deal with that fork ball. I wouldn't be surprised to see him swing.
That should be the policy of all the National League hitters. They've seen the fork ball before, however.
First pitch, 1991 All-Star Game. All-Star Game number 62, and ball one high and away. He couldn't have swung at that one. Win two home runs, and he doesn't care about home runs. He takes a strike. Bill Brinkman said, that's a strike. By the way, we have a microphone on this plate umpire, so you're going to hear some of the happenings down there in the playing field. Edited, of course. Two balls and a strike.
Tape delayed, huh?
I guess Tony Gwynn is a devotee of Ted Williams. He won't swing at a bad pitch. He'll take the walk if you want to give it to him. He hits it a deep short. He's going to get a base hit to start this game. That's typical of his hitting. Knock it around the park and a leadoff single for Tony Gwynn.
It didn't look like Wade Box saw that ball immediately. Kind of shifted to his right foot, and that was his first lean, and then he went back to his left, and the ball was by him by the time he recovered. I don't think he saw that ball well. Let's see if Box picks the ball up at third base real well.
Boggs made some dazzling plays for the Red Sox in recent days.
Much improved third baseman defensively.
Here is Sandberg. Sandberg loves that open space to the right side of the infield, and don't pitch him inside. Low and away, ball one. Tim, I know you love the way Sandberg can turn on a ball.
He's one of the more deadly inside hitters in the game. 187 career home runs as a second baseman. And remember, his first year with the Cubs, he was a third baseman.
Leadoff man is on, and there's a good strike from Jack Morris. Sandberg having a look at the third base coach, Sam Perlazzo. And it wouldn't be beyond Piniella to start a runner with a guy like Sandberg hitting. They play Ryan to pull just a bit. Gwynn draws the throw. Jack Morris had the same thoughts, and Cecil Fielder returns the ball. Jackie Moore also in your picture. Sandberg hurt his hand about a week ago, and even the day after he was hurt, he said, I'm going to the All-Star game. Swing right through that. And the count, one ball, two strikes. Lead off hit by Tony Gwynn. Sandberg is only 2 out of 20 in All-Star games. And 8 strikeouts. And we all know he's a better hitter than that. Foul keeps him up there, 1 and 2. This is the last year of his contract, Tim. It'll be interesting, an option year. It'll be interesting to see what happens after this season.
I think a lot of guys on both teams can talk about the last year of their contract. Bobby Bonilla, the cleanup hitter and the designated hitter for the National League. Last year of his contract, Frank Viola with the Mets. Last year of his contract.
Ozzie Smith on his option year. One ball, two strikes to Sandberg. And that'll be the first out of the game with Dave Henderson making the catch. One on, one out. He made Sandberg reach for that ball. And so Ryan didn't advance Tony Gwynn. And up comes now one of the sweetest swingers in the game from the San Francisco Giants, Will Clark. I noticed the look on his face when Pinella was talking before the game. Let's win one. This is an intense competitor. They all are. There's Henry Aaron, relaxed, sitting, laughing with Lou Pinella. Henry Aaron, the honorary captain of the National League team. Big threat to steal a base, but he has stolen six this year.
You saw that graphic, the fourth start for Will Clark. This is the 21st start for Giant first baseman.
Ball one high outside.
Keep in mind, this is the 62nd All-Star game, so starting for the National League in about a third of the games, actually a little more than a third of the games, have been Giant first baseman. McCovey, Cepeda, Johnny Mize, Whitey Lockman.
And of course, Bill White used to play for them. And the count is now 1-1.
So the one thing that the New York Giants and the San Francisco Giants have not been short of, first baseman, Johnny Mize five times, Cepeda, McCovey, now Clark four times, Bill Terry the first three All-Star games, 33-4-5, and then Whitey Lockman.
Well, what are you going to do with the bat, Will Clark? One on, one out, one ball, one strike here in the opening inning. A strong performer. He has half a dozen complete games under his belt this season.
Wynn could be running. The one thing you mentioned it about Ryan Sandberg, Wynn diving back. Ryan Sandberg and Will Clark, two hitters that are guys that have good bat control and yet power.
One caught the corner. Puts Clark in the hole, 1-2.
A lot of times, powerful swingers lose a little bat control in the process, and guys with bat control don't have a lot of power. But Clark and Sandberg combine both.
There's that split finger delivery. Tim, when a runner is going, and that pitcher throws a split finger, does it make it tough for the catcher to throw?
Well, it does if it's in the dirt, yeah. And particularly for a guy like Sandy Alomar, who doesn't catch many split-fingered pitchers or pitchers who throw that split-fingered pitch. I mean, Jack Morris has eight wild pitches this season. Brian Harper, one of the catchers with the Minnesota Twins, Junior Ortiz, the other. So that splitter in the dirt, certainly wild pitches are up with that pitch of the 90s.
2-2. Wynn at first, he's running. And a base hit. Wynn will go on to third. First and third. Well, that's as many hits as the National League had all of last year at Wrigley Field.
An all-time low for the National League last year as they lost 2-0 on a two-hitter. And Will Clark finds the right guy covering. He hits a low tracer to the right side. Roberto Alomar was covering on the play. Wynn right there. Looking at the line drive and making sure it doesn't hit him. But Roberto Alomar covering on the play, and Clark fortunate that he was, because had he not been, it could have been a double play.
The ball just zipped past, and the batter is Bonilla, and ball one to Bobby.
One would think that Alomar would be covering with Wynn running.
But he was staying, wasn't he?
Yeah.
Bonilla wrapped himself in the head and now wraps the ball and knocks Jack Morris down. And the National League leads 1-0 on their third hit of the inning. And let's hope Jack Morris is okay. We have had some injuries in All-Star games in the past. And we certainly don't want any here. There's not much sympathy in the National League dugout, is there? Bonilla single in an RBI, 1-0 National League.
You hope that line drive got the sole of the shoe as opposed to the foot. I mean, that ball hit with resounding authority, a little one-hopper. And on the artificial surface, of course, a little faster than on grass. Morris appears to be all right. You'll see Morris's reaction once he is hit. And he's smiling about it. I mean, he can't be hurting. Look at him. Look at Bonilla. Morris hit in that area where there's little white showing. Well, we mentioned it early, little white showing. He's wearing those black socks in honor of Scott Sanderson, and that white showing was a baseball.
Well, he's going to be all right, and that's good news. Back in 1937, we had one just like that when Earl Averill lined one off the foot of Dizzy Dean. That was the start of the downfall of Jerome Dizzy Dean.
Well, in the 1950 All-Star Game, Ralph Kiner's drive in the first inning, caught by Ted Williams. He broke his elbow, played the rest of the game, but was out with the Red Sox until September 15th, and the Red Sox ended up losing that season to the Yankees by 3 games.
Well, fortunately, Jack Morris is okay, but unfortunately for him, he has to pitch to Andre Dawson, and he is talking to the catcher.
Here's that 1950 play with Ralph Kiner batting in the first inning, Comiskey Park. Ted Williams in left field made the catch. You can see him grimace with pain. He broke his elbow, played the rest of the game, and was out until September 15th.
Well, Jack Morris is all right, except for his first inning situation. He's given up a run. Park is at second, and Bonilla with the RBI is at first, and Andre Dawson the batter. Ball one. There they are. Infielders at double play depth. Dawson usually gets the ball up in the air. He has that uppercut swing. Don't see many smiles when you watch Andre Dawson as he has a bat in his hand.
Don't see many Hawks smiling, do you?
Look at those eyes. He is intense. He waited for that one, had a heck of a swing and fouled it back. What a swing, one and two.
Watch him commit with that left foot, but keep the bat back. See the left foot commit, the bat is back, and he ended up having a good swing. You can have a good swing if your bat stays back, even though the front part of your body goes forward.
Jack Morris probably said, whoop. One and two. And a ground ball to third. Might be a double play. They got one and two. A double play, and the inning is over. Quite a pivot. Alomar at second base. One run on three hits and one left for the National Leaguers.
Hey, bud, have you heard the news? Catch Huey Lewis in the News Hard at Play Store, brought to you by the King of Beers.
Not long ago, one of the first Luminous sedans was bought by a family of five. They said they liked the gas mileage, all the room it had, and they liked the price. Since then, the Luminous sedan has quickly become the best-selling new car name in America. Apparently, a lot of people are winning with
the heartbeat of America, that's today's Chevrolet.
Now it's easy to win with the heartbeat.
It's not how much you pay that counts, but what you get for your money. This consumer tip was brought to you by Michelin, because so much is riding on your tires.
Did you know the cost of two business calls from these San Diego pet stores to Denver may surprise you?
Of course they're easy to beat.
With AT&T long distance, your small business can get the quality you trust at extremely competitive prices.
They really do make perfect pets.
Even though the other company would like you to believe, they always save you lots of money.
That's my big savings? That's it. Not exactly the catch of the day.
Competitive price, another AT&T advantage.
CBS Sports coverage of the 62nd All-Star Game from Toronto is brought to you by Today's Chevrolet, who invite you to see why more people are winning with the heartbeat of America. Coca-Cola Classic, you can't beat the real thing. AT&T, the right choice. And by Budweiser, with that clean, crisp, cold taste, nothing beats a Bud.
Pretty picture here in Toronto. Way down there on the pitching mound, making his first All-Star game appearance, is the base stater from Massachusetts, Tommy Glavin. He leads the National League in earned run average, 1.98. He's 1-12, lost 4. He's second in earned run average, only to Scott Erickson of Minnesota.
Defensively for the National League, Ivan Calderon, the left fielder. When Darryl Strawberry said he would not play, Calderon was named as the starter. Tony Gwynn and his four gold gloves in center, Andre Dawson in right field. Chris Sabo, rookie of the year 3 years ago at third. Ozzie Smith at shortstop. Ryan Sandberg at second. Will Clark, the first baseman. And behind the plate, Benito out Santiago.
How do you think they'd like a lineup like that in Denver or Miami in 1993?
I don't think they're going to have a lineup like that. That's an excellent point. I salivate for lineups like these.
Ricky Henderson leads it off. And a strike, barks the umpire. You'll notice Tommy Glavin can't work quickly enough. He wants the ball back, and he wants to come back at him again. And that ball is going to be Will Clark territory, and he caught the ball.
Wow.
Great play. Great play. I didn't think he was going to get it.
Talk about his power, talk about his leadership, talk about everything, but he is an excellent defensive first baseman, and that was a real catch 22.
Oh, catch 22. You know, another guy was terrific at that, Bill White.
Mm-hmm.
And you played with him,
mm-hmm.
Jim.
Certainly did. Now the National League president.
Now ball one to Wade Boggs. Up to his old tricks, hitting 324. With a terrific lifetime batting mark. One ball two the count. And the youngster, wonder what he just finished eating.
Something sticky.
2-0 to Boggs, 1-0 National League. And 3-0. Glavin's strikeout, base on balls ratio is wonderful. 108 strikeouts, only 21 walks. But he's nervous and he walks. Another fellow who's having a wonderful season is the Minnesota manager, Tom Kelly. He's coaching at third. And what an ovation, you heard it, for Cito Gaston, the head man of the Blue Jays. He's coaching at first.
I think the interesting thing about the crowd before the game, when they introduced the National League, the crowd gave ovations for National League players that had played formerly in the American League, and that was really nice.
And a robust mixed greeting for George Bell when that happened. Here's Cal Ripken Jr.
That was to be expected.
Playing every day has certainly hurt the performance of Cal Ripken Jr., hasn't
it? Yeah. Leading the American League in hitting with a 348 average, 18 home runs, having possibly his best year ever.
There's a hit. It's the first of the night for the American League. Maybe we are going to have some sparks here. First and second, one out. Well, who do you want up there now?
Ripken in that crouch this year. Last year, he was a straight up and down hitter, but he has crouched, and that has helped him immeasurably. Smokes that ball to center field. First hit for the American League.
And there is Ripken. At first with Boggs down at second and Fielder at the plate. Cecil walks up and chased a bad ball down and in. Mr. Fielder has 21 home runs.
Slider out of the strike zone. Nice play by Santiago, the catcher.
Two on, one out. Fooled me once, but not twice with that same pitch. One ball, one strike. Fox Baxter will walk with one out. And Ripken singled him down to second. And the National League has a run, which could be erased by Susser. Two balls and a strike. Lavin, as we've indicated, usually much better with his control than he is demonstrating here in the first. It's a foul right. It's one thing about Fielder. He can go the other way and hurt you. And not necessarily with a home run. He's a clever hitter.
Remarkable that only 5 years ago, Cecil Fielder and Fred McGriff of the San Diego Padres were platooning with the Toronto Blue Jays. And last year, between the two of them, they had 87 home runs, 51 for Fielder, 36 for McGriff.
Where is Fred McGriff? He should be here.
One of the real injustices of this game, I think. I mean, he was fourth in the voting, popular voting, second behind Will Clark, who is the starting first baseman, but Eddie Murray was named as a replacement. Not that Eddie's not having a great year, but Fred McGriff a little better.
And a strikeout for Glavin on a pitch high and away, the second out of the inning. That typifies Detroit this year, home run or strikeout. And doing well, the Tigers are.
Cecil Fielder with 182 strikeouts last year. Waves at the high fastball from Glavin.
So this Toronto crowd will root for one of the enemy during the regular season, Danny Tartable, and he's been on a tear. He's hit 20 home runs for the year, two on, two out. You hear a little chatter coming from the dugouts. National League leading 1-0 in the first. Runners at first and second, two out. That's a strange number Benito Santiago is wearing.
Yeah, he's worn it for the past few weeks, and the public relations people of the San Diego Padres says he's wearing it just to be different. As Tartable goes after what would have been ball three, a little anxious. You see that in a game like this.
Good pitch. Cut it that one, 2-2.
0-9. It's like two-thirds of an area code.
Anything can happen in baseball these days. Benito, what a great catcher. That's going to go foul. I never saw Ted Williams wear an earring when he was playing. Or Jody.
Times have changed. Fashions have changed, Jack.
Oh, to be different. Can he catch? Can he throw?
Best throwing arm I've ever seen, and it's remarkable when you consider two catchers who were spawned in the San Diego Padre organization starting the All-Star game this year. They would have started it last year in Chicago, but Santiago had the broken wrist.
Strike three called on the inside corner. Second strikeout for Glavin, and the National League leads it 1-0.
Of all the trucks in its class, only Chevy four-door S10 Blazer gives you four-wheel anti-lock brakes, standard, which helps you steer through a curve while braking. Without it, you don't have as much control. And why should that be important to you? Because in the real world, safety doesn't have to be an option. Chevy S10 Blazer.
The heartbeat of America. Today's truck is Chevrolet.
Boys of Summer. The legend. legends of the game. Players like Babe Ruth, Lou Gehrig, and Ty Cobb. Now presented in never-before-seen color home movies. Movies shot by fellow players and fans. Capture the glory of the golden age of baseball. When it was a game. Now playing only on HBO.
Here's news. If your athlete's foot won't go away, you could have more than athlete's foot. You could have a secondary yeast infection. That's right, yeast.
Only Mycotin cures both athlete's foot and secondary yeast infections with miconazole. Step up to the mic, Mycotin.
Kelly LeBrock reveals the essence of man.
Hard to define, easy to know.
When he holds you close,
it's in the way he smells. Root, the essence of man. Come on, put it on.
Taste that's out of this world. You can't beat the real thing.
Do you favor the use of instant replay as an officiating tool in sports? You can register your vote by calling this AT&T MultiQuest 900 service number, 1-900-436-9000. Each call will cost 95 cents. You must be 18 years or older to vote. You'll have the chance to vote on four different sports.
There's Cal Ripken playing shortstop for the American League, and we had a few words from his mother about Cal when he was a youngster. We'll catch up with that in a moment. Ivan Calderon takes ball one from Jack Morris. Second inning, 1-0 National League. Calderon got a nice hand from the crowd. He's playing in Montreal these days. And a foul makes the count 1-1. Calderon, Sabo, and Benito Santiago in this inning. In case you just joined us, and I hope that's not the case, I hope you saw Ted Williams and Joe DiMaggio introduced and caught all of the other action. Three hits in the first inning. Win, Will Clark, and an RBI hit by Bobby Bonilla. Count 2-1 to Calderon. National League dugout. Juan Samuel, Felix Jose, Bonilla, Dawson. High. And it's 3-1. I think the most surprising stat about this batter is the fact that he's been stealing bases for the Montreal club.
Stealing about it as many as Tim Raines, the person for whom he was traded from the White Sox, would have stolen.
He has 20. And he's going to be on base. Good piece of hitting there as he waited.
Hitter, you can only do what the pitcher allows you to do. If he throws the ball away, you can't try to pull it. You play Pepper with the shortstop all night long. So Calderon with a fastball away smokes it the other way.
Not only away, but down a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And that is the fourth hit for the National Leaguers. The batter is Sabo of the world champion Cincinnati Reds. Ball one.
First Red, the third baseman to start two straight All-Star games. Pete Rose did it back in 1976 and 78, two of the 3 years. Pete, of course, there you are. Pete, of course, starting the All-Star game in five different positions.
On a hit and run, they'll miss the runner at second and get Sabo at first, but they did advance the runner. Pinella has him on the move.
Two innings, two hit and run plays. The first one very successful, and this one successful in that Calderon gets to second base. Even though you sacrifice an out in the process, Morris wanted to go to second, elects to go to first.
Well, Sabo did move the runner along, and to the plate is Benito Santiago, who's driven in 39 runs for the Padres this year. He's happy to be playing this year. Broken arm a year ago. He was jammed. Strike one. This crowd is revved up, and they are having fun. And the National League has four base hits and a 1-0 lead, and Santiago could increase that. One out.
Hey, tonight you're seeing a piece of Americana with DiMaggio and Williams, and a piece of North Americana with Toronto, the host city. A remarkable structure this is. SkyDome opened in June of 1989 as Jimmy Key, who lost the first game in June of 1989 for the Toronto Blue Jays, the first game played in this ballpark.
So Jack Morris might not pitch the maximum three innings. 0-1 to Benico and way high. Santiago doesn't do it, the Wizard will have a shot at it. Ozzie Smith. And the count 1-2. Morris has no strikeouts. He has Santiago's setup. Keeping a wary eye on Calderon. The ball is foul, keeping it 1-2.
These are the best of times and the worst of times for Jack Morris. He's going through a very, very acrimonious divorce settlement, and yet he's back home pitching, having a terrific year for a team that's tied for first place. Best of times and the worst of times for Jack.
Santiago hits another foul, and I'm still watching Calderon down there at second base, Tim. He looks like he'll go if Alomar ignores him. And one of our first looks at Tony La Russa. He is managing the American League All-Stars for the third year in a row and looking for another victory.
And if he wins this game, he'll be the first American League manager to win three games in a row. Stengel did it 3 years in a row, but he lost the first game that they played back in 1959.
There goes the runner stealing, and he stole it as Santiago strikes out.
Jack Buck has the National League signs. Calderon, we mentioned, 20 stolen bases during the year, and this is the best time to try to steal third base with one out. You don't try with nobody out. You don't want to make the first out at third. You don't try with two outs because you don't want to make the third out at third. And that's why with one out, it's the best time to do it, but Santiago ends up striking out for the second out.
And it took a good play by Boggs to avoid an error. Ball went way high to Ozzie Smith. And you have noticed that we are using the designated hitter here this evening. Lou Piniella is familiar with that from his Yankee days. Ball two to Smith. What a season Ozzie is having. He is hitting 315. People are wondering if he's going to be in St. Louis next year. He'll be somewhere. And he hits the ball foul. 2-1. Ozzie says, Tim, he wants to play shortstop until he's 40 years old.
He's the oldest shortstop in the major leagues right now, 36, so that's another 3 or 4 years. I think a team would probably go ahead and give him a 3-year contract. I mean, he's playing like he's 26, not 36. Fastball away to Smith.
Runner at third, two out, 2-2. Fastball away, evens the count. Calderon led off with a single. Sable moved him along. Stole third as Santiago struck out, and it's up to Smith. 3-2.
Jack Morris and Alomar go. Fastball away again.
And out of play. You use the DH. There's no breathing room for a pitcher.
Not when your number nine hitter hits 315.
And Tony Gwynn waits on deck.
Right. It's the second time the designated hitter has been used in All-Star play. The first time, 1989 in Anaheim. Another fastball away.
Another one out of play as Smith protects the plate. Souvenir. There's the President of the United States, George Bush, enjoying the game, and Pat O'Brien will be joining him next inning. If he can get past his security. As he lines it to Ripken, and it's still 1-0. One hit, one left.
It's happening. Some people are climbing out of their imports and getting into the 1991 Buick Regal sedan. Why? One simple, overwhelming consideration. Quality. Buick quality. It's something you might want to get into yourself. Regal from Buick. The new symbol for quality in America and beyond.
Step in. Out for extra comfort on the move. The underwear is through the loom.
For the extra comfort of ribbed cotton, the extra style of a trimmer fit, more men are switching to ribbed whites, only from Fruit of the Loom.
On the street, on the town, for extra comfort on the move. The underwear is Fruit of the Loom.
Thirsty. There's one thing everybody's got to have. Because deep down, we all want the same thing. The cool, crisp taste, the fluids, minerals, and energy of Gatorade.
Gatorade Thirst Quencher. For that deep down body thirst.
The Yankee Clipper.
Busy day for the President of the United States. He was in the Rose Garden honoring Ted Williams and Joe DiMaggio with a plaque.
Well, thank you all.
All their great accomplishments in 1941. And tonight, the President is in Toronto enjoying a little baseball game. Thank you for joining us, Mr. President.
Delighted to be here.
I must say that that protocol dictates that I turn to the Prime Minister first. We are in Canada. And Mr. Prime Minister...
I'm a better hitter than the President.
Is baseball becoming a North American pastime now?
Started in Montreal in 69 with the Expos. They've had a marvelous run at it. And this franchise in Toronto has developed into one of the strongest in the majors, as you can see from the crowd tonight.
Your accomplishments, among them, you have become almost the baseball president. You were a great first baseman at Yale, and you love the game. The commissioner tells me you call him and talk about the game. Your son's one of the owners of the Rangers. What is it you love so much about the game?
I just love being out here. I know the game fairly well. I like the intricacies of the game. And it's really just being at the ball game, relaxing, watching the play, trying to figure out what they're going to do. It's marvelous. I tried to explain that to the Queen of England, and I'm not sure I got through to her, but it was great. I love it. I relax here. I went to a minor league ball game the other night, Class A ball, Frederick Keys, and had as much fun almost as seeing this All-Star.
You know, one of the great pictures I've ever seen in baseball is the one of you and Babe Ruth when he came to Yale to dedicate a manuscript there.
Well, Babe was near the end of his life then, and yes, he presented some of his papers to Yale Library, and I was playing ball at Yale and got to meet him. It was a real thrill. Could hardly talk then. He's ridden with cancer, but everybody knew they were standing in the presence of greatness.
I always think of that quote that Babe Ruth said, I had a better year than Hoover. I guess you could say you're having a better year than Hoover, too. Huh?
I hope so. I hope so.
But I just missed
there with these two guys.
He's a great sportsman, as you all know, and I just missed you in my beloved South Dakota. You caught, what, six trout out there?
Five, I think. And make it six.
How big one?
Well, no, they were little guys.
Thank you both for joining us. By the way, do you guys know somebody? How'd you get these tickets up here?
I'm the guest of one of the great men here, Brian Mulroney.
Thank you. Mr. President, nice to see you. Enjoy the evening. Top that, fellas.
And you folks just saw a big swing by Ken Griffey Jr. after Dave Henderson struck out. Dave is going to go back and find out that while he was batting, Pat was talking with the president and the prime minister. But he struck out, so but we caught you, Dave. You'll get him next time. That's Hindu. And Ken Griffey Jr. up. One ball, one strike. Low. Now Glavin has struck out the last three. He's getting with the program here. 1-0, National League. Second inning. We were setting up that camera shot. Pat O'Brien talked about protocol. He said to the president and the prime minister, would you guys mind standing up? You guys.
What's he going to say, y'all?
High in the air to the center fielder, Gwynn. And that's the second out of the inning. American League has one hit and a walk and two out and nobody on. Gwynn is not usually a center fielder, but he can play out there.
Played 89 games there last year. There's a center fielder for you right there.
Here's Sandy Alomar Jr.
Actually, that was 1989, the last time that Tony Gwynn played 89 games in center field. So 89 and 89.
Kim, did you tell me that Sandy Alomar Sr. flew up from Puerto Rico for the action?
He's here at the game, right? He is now a traveling infield instructor with the Chicago Cub minor league system, but he's here tonight, yes.
One ball, one strike to Sandy. He doesn't really have all-star stats. No home runs, four RBIs, hitting 241, but the fans like him, so here he is.
Rookie of the year in the American League last year.
Jammed and he flies it out to Tony Gwynn. Glavin has retired five in a row and after two, National League 1-0.
I'm an athlete, not an actor.
Let me out of this thing.
I got rehab to do.
Oh.
Give me those shoes.
Oh.
Excuse me.
Nice shoes.
You watch too much TV, kid.
Oh, no,
hey! Where's that music coming from?
Oh, no,
you know I don't have time for this. But I do. Hit it!
Josh Stone, it's got that air thing!
Josh Stone?
Okay, for it and Marcus. Say, do I love Diet A&W root beer and cream soda with 100% nutrition? And action! No, my right. No, into the glass, into the glass. What do you need, glasses or are you just stupid?
I've been told both.
It's the taste that made A&W famous.
The driver of this car adds something special to his motor oil. So does the driver of this car. They both use STP oil treatment. For drivers on a racetrack or drivers on a fast track, STP.
I want him to have a good time.
To me, safety's keeping out of an accident.
But I just want him safe.
You know when you slam on the brakes and the car all of a sudden has a mind of its own? With these GM anti-lock brakes, you can stop on a dime and steer while you're doing it.
You know, he's only 16.
We think quality starts with safety. That's why we have more models with anti-lock brakes than anybody else in the world.
GM safety. It's not one thing. It's everything.
You're watching CBS Sports coverage of the 1991 All-Star Game.
We've played two innings, and they announced Jimmy Key as the new pitcher for the American League. Listen. He's having a wonderful season with a record of 10-4.
Now the Blue Jays, pardon me, Jack, the Blue Jays with
four of the top 10 leaders in the American League, leading in earned run average. Jimmy Key, one of them. Also Brad Wells, Dave Steeb, and Tom Candiotti. Blue Jays really with a tough pitching staff.
That's why they're 5.5 ahead of Boston. Here's Tony Gwynn. And he lines it right at center field. Well, we told you about Cal Ripken. Here is his mother.
Hard for an 8 or 9 year old, and he hit one batter, and he hit two batters, and he hit three batters, and the coach like calls times, and he goes out and he says a few words to Cal, and he came over to me and he said, Cal looked up at me and said, they don't move out of the way very fast, do they?
Used to be a pitcher, and what a shortstop and hitter he has become. Sandberg is up, one out. Ball one, ball two. We have other family portraits to show you this evening. Adding to the spice and our adoration of the game. Ball, call it a strike, 2-1.
I wonder how many games in a row Cal Ripken played as a little leaguer. He's played 1,491, second to Lou Gehrig. Remarkable.
And the count 2-2 to, or 3-1 is Ryan Sandberg.
Setting up inside. That's a lack of knowledge about Ryan Sandberg. He is a deadly inside hitter. Now Alomar back outside, but Key goes inside.
And we got a strike, 3-2. Alomar having difficulty hanging on.
Well, that's common in the All-Star game because your catcher catches so many different styles of pitchers that he's not familiar with.
Sandberg fly to right his first time. Keep pitching him inside, will you? Up against, and Sandberg will get to it with one out. You can't pitch Sandberg there.
There are some guys you say you mix it up, you get to a point where you want, you pitch him outside, inside. This guy is a dead inside hitter. He doesn't miss it too often, as he shows on that fastball inside. It was up. If you come inside on Ryan Sandberg, it better be way, way inside.
That's the first extra base hit by the National League in an All-Star game since 87.
Wow. They haven't homered in the last 6 years.
Really?
Right.
That one got by me. Here's Will Clark with a runner at second. One out and strike one. Will single to right his first time. Two years ago, they gave Clark the Silver Spike Award, emblematic of the best collegiate player. They knew what they were doing, didn't they, Tim?
Down in Mississippi State, Rafael Palmeiro and that strong-hitting Texas lineup now. Palmeiro signing with the Cubs, going down to Texas. Texas ahead in the American League West.
Fielder to the pitcher, Key. Two out, runner at third. Will Clark was bested by Jimmy Key. He hates it. He hates it when he doesn't get a hit. Look at that puss.
Will the thrill.
And it's up to Bobby Bonilla, who drove home the first inning run, bouncing one off the ankle of Jack Morris, who pitched two innings, one run, four hits, struck out one, walked none. This Toronto pitcher has had some arm miseries in the past, and we're happy to see that he's overcome those and doing well. One and one.
It's Dave Steeb of the Blue Jays that's on the shelf now, and that's what prompted the trade for Tom Candiotti. Roger Clemens now in the pen. They've got to have in the pen. They keep coming at you, don't they?
That's a strange feeling for him to be warming up in the bullpen during a game.
And it's got to be even stranger for Jimmy Key. This is his first bullpen appearance since 1986. He'll take it, though. It's an All-Star game, right?
Right. He has a runner at third, two out. behind to Bonilla. And a foul, 2-2. National League got a run in the first on hits by Gwynn, Bart, and Bonilla. Sandberg perched at third, two out. To the SkyDome after this message and a word from your local station.
In the past 2 years, one TV show has actually been credited with saving more than 50 lives. So if you think you can live without watching television for one night, make sure it isn't Tuesday.
The show is Rescue 911. The look is CBS.
This relationship could work, except for one problem.
Every guy I go out with ends up dead.
I just want to talk.
So talk.
Can you put the axe down?
Northern Exposure, Monday.
This is CBS.
When it came to redefining the word luxury, it wasn't a Webster. It was Oldsmobile.
The 98 defines luxury in terms of how much you get, not how much you spend. Anti-lock brakes, fuel-efficient power, computerized suspension, technology found in cars costing thousands more, which could be the greatest luxury of all.
And you can always take a Webster at his word.
This is the new 98, luxury redefined.
Generation of Olds.
There is a new gasoline that is clearly advanced. A new gasoline that will give you the highest level of engine cleaning for high performance. A new gasoline formulated for lower pollution and cleaner air. Who has this new gasoline? You know who. New Phase 4 gasoline from Exxon. For high performance and cleaner air.
After years of intense work, Lexus is ready to celebrate. Because even at the equivalent of 145 miles per hour, the Lexus LS400 is designed to stir the soul and not much else.
Calorie counting and exercise. Channel 10 News at 11.
Way down here, the score is 1-0 National League. One of the hot teams in baseball, the Yankees.
2-2.
Barfield's first pitch, line drive, base hit to right field. Sierra up with the ball. Here comes Sack. Here comes the throw. He is safe.
Barfield's got a beat on it, and he's got it. Davis tag. Oh, here comes the throw, and
holy cow, what a throw!
Holy cow, what a throw. You see those Yankees against the Angels Sunday at 2:30 Eastern Time with the pregame show. And on that pregame show, more of the Ted Williams, Joe DiMaggio interview. So catch it early. We have a new pitcher, Dennis Martinez, and the batter from the Blue Jays. So we don't know who they're rooting for, Martinez from Montreal or Roberto Alomar. He's batting in the number 9 spot. Bottom of the third, 1-0 National League. Martinez, 10-5. Out of play.
One of four brother combinations to start an All-Star game. Morton Walker Cooper did it for the Cardinals back in 42-3. Dixie and Harry Walker in 47. Joe and Dom DiMaggio in 49.
And so here,
this is the first time in 42 years that brothers have started for the same team in an All-Star game.
This fellow coming over from San Diego is quickly a big favorite with Toronto, hitting .283, five home runs. That's out of play. 1-2.
Strange thing, Jack, about that 47 season when Dixie and Harry Walker started for the National League. Dixie Walker playing for the Dodgers. Harry Walker was traded from the Cardinals to the Phillies in midseason, and he was with the Phillies when he started the All-Star game and ended up leading the league in hitting that year.
Walker.
One of our good friends down in Leeds, Alabama, Harry Walker. Ooh, ooh, don't do that to our hometown boy. 2-2, and that is not unlike Martinez.
Pitch inside for effect. You can see Santiago sitting inside. I wonder what Sandy Alomar thought about that knockdown pitch.
He probably laughed. Yeah.
Look at that.
Got him. We got him.
That'll wake you up, Roberto.
Now the count 3-2 to the leadoff hitter in the American League third. Out of play. His folks will have to tell him that he was at the All-Star game in 91. He's happy, though.
Two people for one ticket.
All-Star game Toronto. They say that this game has infused more than $30 million into the local economy.
Wow.
Anybody going to get that one? Maybe not. Yep, Calderon. This crowd was rooting so hard for a home run.
Got this Toronto crowd on their feet, didn't it? This ball low and away from Martinez. Alomar, I mean, just think, he was voted in, and it was his first time in the American League. Usually the guys, look at that, leaning forward, look at Sandy. Usually a guy needs a little time in the league before he's voted in by the fans, but here Roberto Alomar traded the first year and voted in by the fans, first year in the American League. What a talent.
And so the batter now is Ricky Henderson. And a hit. That is the second of the evening by the American League. Now we'll get some base running action.
Now things are going to heat up a little bit.
Tim, you and I both know how clever Dennis Martinez is at keeping runners close.
This should be a great battle between Martinez and Henderson. Ricky with a second American League hit. Martinez with a terrific move to first base. Henderson with 966 stolen bases. All-time leader. He'll probably end up, if he stays healthy, with about 1,500. That's his goal.
The way Martinez can hold runners, the way Henderson can run, the way Boggs can bat, this is going to take 5 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
He took a pitch to give Henderson a chance to run. Strike one.
This will be about like the last 40 seconds of an NBA game right here.
One on, one out, and Henderson has stolen 966. There's his manager. Is he on the move? Fitz Clark dropped the ball. He would have been out. So the American League has two on, and that might be an error, or they might give him a hit.
Yeah, Sandberg made such a sparkling play on that ball, throwing off balance. He had nothing on the throw, but it did. I agree with you. It looked like John McSherry, the first base umpire, had that right hand cupped ready to punch him out. Henderson stopping on the great play by Sandberg, and now the one hopper over there. Had Clark held on, they'd probably get the call. You could see that right hand being cupped up by John McSherry, but Clark drops the ball.
And they rule it a base hit for Boggs. So he's been on base twice. The reason I groaned when he was running is that Boggs hit the ball and Henderson would have stolen the base. And the batter, Ripken. Tip. National League manager wants to hang on to the 1-0 lead. This is his first time managing an All-Star team. And there's La Russa. He wants a hit from Ripken.
Speaking of first times, I wonder how many times Cal Ripken Jr. has faced his former teammate. The answer, none. First time.
Talking about Dennis Martinez. one strike. Ricky Henderson has thoughts about stealing third base. If he does so, he'll do it against a very good catcher, Benito Santiago.
Both Santiago and Alomar, very unusual. They throw from their knees as well as they do standing up.
It's amazing what they can do. Two on, one out. Inside, 2-1. Bottom of the third. 1-0 National League. Two on, one out for the American. Sandberg working at keeping Henderson close at second base. In fact, he's out of position in so doing.
But the likelihood of Ripken going the other way, remote. That's why Sandberg's holding him close and not the shortstop, Ozzie Smith. Smith has to protect against the pull side, and Sandberg can hold Henderson close because not too many ground balls to the right side by Ripken.
He hammered that one, and Gwynn's on the run. On the run. Forget it. Tuned up yesterday in the home run hitting contest.
Did he ever? We mentioned 22 at bats yesterday, 12 home runs, far and away the best in the home run hitting contest. And he duplicates that feat. Two at bats tonight, has 18 during the season. And I mean a hanging curveball. And Ripken says, Benito, I'll handle this one.
Well, how about back to back, Cecil? Fielder fanned his first time. 3-1 American.
Big league hitters rarely let pitches like this pass. That's all about belt high, breaking right into that zone of Ripken, and he hammered it out of here.
3-1 American League. 1-2 to Fielder. 2-2. He was looking hopefully at the plate umpire. You're not going to call me out, are you? This is the most pleasant of people. Cecil Fielder. He spoiled that good pitch.
We mentioned Cal Ripken Jr. yesterday with 12 and 22 swings. Nothing to it, huh, Cal?
Easy.
12 home runs and 22 swings yesterday. That one hitting the facade in the upper deck.
And he has stung the National League here in the third. 3-2 to the big man. For Dennis, first of all, the line drive by Alomar that was caught. Single by Henderson, single by Boggs, and a home run by Ripken. Up the middle, and there's Sandberg. He knows how to play on the AstroTurf, even though he plays on a grass field in Chicago. Two out.
That is a designed throw. He was throwing off balance on that ball hit by Boggs, but watch how Sandberg, realizing that all he has to do is get it online with Fielder running. He throws the ball intentionally onto the rug, and Clark with a scoop. First one that I can remember doing that, shortstop Davey Concepcion with the Cincinnati Reds. Trajectory of the ball is lower, and the rug allows the true hop.
And with two on, Danny Turnbull is up. He fanned his first time. Tommy Glavin pitched two innings. No runs, one hit, struck out three, walked one. And Dennis Martinez started this inning fresh, and he's been roughed up. And that's the way the fans like it. Action. Two balls and a strike. Get that home run. Three runs, three hits, 3-1. American League on top.
Yo, Morris Blackman here at NBA Finals. See what makes Michael Jordan the best.
Is it the shoes?
It had to be the shoes.
Team. Catch it this season.
How do we get the truck back?
Throw it in reverse.
Let's go.
They were on their way to the top, but a few old men were spoiling all their fun. It was time for some new blood. Christian Slater, Patrick Dempsey, Richard Grieco. Monsters, rated R, starts July 26th.
When you have a lot of horses under your hood, shouldn't you have Michelin high-performance tires under your car?
There's a rush in the wind, there's a road on the rise, and you feel like you're ready to fly.
You hear the crack of the thunder, oh, you gotta go.
This game summary is sponsored by Budweiser.
Bobby Bonilla put the National League on top, but Cal Ripken did something about that with a three-run homer. They've taken Jack Morris to the hospital for x-rays of his foot. And this is when he was struck by the batted ball off Bonilla's bat, which drove in the run. He continued to pitch, but now he's on the way to the hospital. Fourth inning. Andre Dawson, who grounded into a double play in the first, is up, and he'll face Roger Clemens. Ball one. Hello. Clemens is 11-5 with a 2.22 ERA. You don't shake this fellow. Joe Carter, whose name you see there, is in left field. And Andre Dawson is the batter. In the fourth. That ball is foul, out of play. Let's go and join Jim Kahn at this moment. Jim?
All right, thanks, Jack. National League starter Tom Glavine, three strikeouts, a hit. Was the confrontation with Boggs all you thought it would be?
Well, I didn't live up to my end of the bargain. I think he got up there and I tried to relax a little bit too much and didn't throw anything near the plate, unfortunately. But I made it through and everything's all right.
It's fun to play baseball in Atlanta again, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. We're having a lot of fun down there playing. I know the fans are having a lot of fun. We just want to keep winning and keep things going and hopefully stay in the pennant race as long as we can.
Got a great young pitching staff behind you. More guys down there.
Yeah, we do. We've got a few more guys in the minor leagues that are pressing us up there in the big leagues for some jobs. So we're going to have to make us pitch a little bit harder, and hopefully they can come up and help us out, and it'll be a welcome addition.
Great job, Tom. Thanks for the visit. Back to Jack and Tim.
Okay, Jim Conk. Glavine pitched two innings, no runs, one hit, struck out three, walked one. Count has gone to 3-2 on Dawson. Speaking of the Braves, they resume Wednesday, Thursday night at home. against St. Louis. Austin corks it to center. How far did you hit that one, Andre? Look out wherever you are. What a home run. It's 3-2. That ball went more than 450 feet, I would guess, Tim.
Well, all you have to do is watch the reaction of Ken Griffey Jr. I tell you, Roger the Rocket Clemens was aptly named after that pitch. What a rocket.
You think that would have been out of Wrigley Field?
Probably.
Ivan Calderon is up. Strike one to him.
Remember, Clemens had come inside with the fastballs, and now he goes away. And Dawson knew it, and so did Ken Griffey Jr. Two steps back. Two steps, we're going to have a ball. Isn't that the song? Not this time.
And there's one by Calderon, but it's playable. In center field by Griffey for the first out of the inning.
We mentioned the reaction of Ken Griffey Jr. on the ball hit by Dawson. Look, 1-2. Two steps, no ball this time.
That's reminiscent of the Bo Jackson home run in Anaheim
in
89.
Right, against Rick Rueschel.
That makes it a one-run game, 3-2 American League. Sabo. Ball on strike. Delay call by Joe Brinkman. Strike one.
The last Cubs player to hit an All-Star game home run was 1964 when Billy Williams hammered one out. Shea Stadium.
Sabo went around and that's strike two. First National League All-Star home run in a long time. Seven games. And it was a beaut.
To chop that one up and have a couple of two or three home runs out of that thing. Ooh.
1-2 to Sabo, one out.
Johnson of the New York Mets. We mentioned Shea Stadium. Well, Hojo leading the National League in a ton of offensive categories. And his wife is here, his wife Kim, and she is with child and due any moment, really. The baby was initially due the latter part of July. It's going to come prematurely, and she wanted to come see the SkyDome. That's why she's here. She got an okay from the doctor because she wanted to come to Toronto to see SkyDome. See, Hojo saying, yep, that's right.
He can't hear you, though. Sabo hits one to left, and Joe Carter just into the game. That's the second out. Guess who Pat O'Brien is with?
Oh, with Kim Johnson. And why are you here, anyway?
I'm here to watch Howard play.
Kim, it's not really any minute, is it? But you are imminent, right?
Yeah, it's not any minute, but I'm up here, and I know some people probably think, why is she up here? Because she's 9 months pregnant. But in baseball, we're away from our family so much that I just didn't want to be away from him if I did go into labor, and he's playing here and I'm at home. So I thought I'd take the chance and come up here. And we made it a matter of prayer, and I know the Lord's watching over us, and we're going to make it through this.
I'm going to ask you something. Do you have a plan if for any reason you go into labor here?
Yeah, I have a doctor. Actually, I found out he was a Mets pitcher a long time ago. So I've got a doctor in a hospital, and I have my prenatal records with me, and we're all right. I feel fine about it.
Good
making
luck.
Everybody else nervous around me, though.
I'm afraid to sit by you.
Yeah.
What do you think of the SkyDome, by the way?
It's great. Oh, it's great. Yeah, it's a really a nice stadium. I'm so thankful that I am here.
We'll help you out if you need help.
The food's great, too.
Yeah. Up here eating munchies with Kim. Back to you guys.
And that doctor's name is Ron Taylor. He used to pitch for the Mets and for the Cardinals.
And the team physician for the Toronto Blue Jays and still throws batting practice for the Blue Jays.
He's an orthopedic surgeon.
But he likes to throw batting practice. What can I tell you?
Benito Santiago drills one to center for Ken Griffey Jr. And the inning is over. One run for Dawson. 3-2 American League. Bottom of the fourth.
Whether I'm racing 200 miles an hour or driving 55, I don't accept compromises. You shouldn't either. Cars should be responsive, yet fuel efficient. Roomy, yet sleek. Not to mention affordable.
Well, surprisingly, one car does all that and more. The new Cutlass Supreme.
So take a look at any new Cutlass Supreme and see for yourself.
Here's one car that does it all and does it right.
New generation of all.
Coca-Cola sponsors Upper Deck Hologram Baseball Cards at Denny's.
Everyone wants these cards that turn into real players.
What?
You said with a Grand Slam and a Coca-Cola Classic, we'd get this hologram card that makes players come to life.
I said it makes players look like they've come to life.
Right. That hologram looks just like Wally Joyner.
It is Wally Joyner.
The card works. Let's get more at Lenny's.
Denny's.
Have a Grand Slam and a Coca-Cola Classic and get an Upper Deck hologram baseball card. Only at Denny's.
Okay, I'm going to say a word. You say the first thing that comes to your mind. Ready?
Okay, shoot.
Husband.
Wife.
South.
Football.
Sophisticated?
Comedy.
Small town?
Big laughs.
Sex?
Bigger laughs.
Bigger laughs?
The show is Evening Shade. The look is CBS.
In the tropics, he's the only private eye.
Trust me.
He's Nick Slaughter, a man full of surprises.
There's Nicky.
Keeping on top of the island's foul play.
I just wanted you for your body.
And a watchful eye out, even when things are looking up. Sweating bullets after the flash. Friday.
Stephen King takes you on this summer's most shocking journey.
Something happened to him.
When a man discovers there is something more frightening than growing old.
You don't look the way you did 2 weeks ago. You look the way you did 2 years ago.
Growing young.
I could disappear without a trace.
Stephen King's Golden Years next Tuesday.
We're catching a break in this one here in Toronto. 3-2, the American League leading. A couple of home runs. We've had some action. Henderson and Griffey coming up. And that's Felix Jose playing right field. And there's Dawson. He's out of the game. He did enough, I would say. Yeah, boy, Andre. We're rooting for all these players to all have a good night. Dave Henderson. Breaking ball, strike from Dennis Martinez. He struck out his first time while Pat O'Brien was talking to the president. One ball, one strike. Good pitch downstairs, 1-2. And Griffin and second Alomar. Well, this fellow carried the Oakland A's for a long time this year, Tim.
He carried a lot of ball clubs. The Boston Red Sox back in 1986, last half of the season.
He waited but popped it up into short center, and it's going to be caught by Tony Gwynn. First out, fourth inning. Well, here's the way the scoring has gone. Bobby Bonilla drove home the first run, bounced it off the leg of Jack Morris. Ripken hit a long three-run homer, made it 3-1, and Dawson changed the score. And how? We've had 10 hits already. Ken Griffey Jr. flied out his first time. Martinez kept it away from him.
Hey, you mentioned Dave Henderson. It's so nice to see him finally getting some notoriety. Great postseason player. Be 33 years old in 9 days, his first All-Star game.
Hard hit and no chance for Sandberg.
What I was leading up to then, you may be wondering who the oldest All-Star non-pitcher has been as you're looking at the Seattle Mariners second-year player, Ken Griffey Jr. He was the first Seattle player to be selected as a starter last year, his second straight start. And the oldest player, Satchel Paige, 47. Pete Rose is 44. Carl Yastrzemski, 43. And Carlton Fisk, 43. But the oldest first-time player was Babe Ruth, 1933. He was 38 years old, and the reason was there were no All-Star games before then.
Ozzie will get the force out with Sandberg for the second out of the inning. 6-4 is the way it went. Here's the president of the National League, Bill White. Bill, you're behind by a run. And another greeting for Roberto Alomar. Hit the ball hard but out into left field his first time. Runner at first, two gone. Second inning of work for Dennis Martinez. President of the American League is Dr. Bobby Brown. And he leads by a run, 3-2, fourth inning. The switch hitter up there with a one ball, one strike count. Griffey single with one out. He's at first, two out. Let's go down to Jim Cott again. James?
Well, Jack, All-Star games, as you mentioned, not without injuries. And Jack Morris with me right now. How's the foot?
It's reverse.
Are you going to get it x-rayed?
Yeah, they're going to take me over. It's a little tender in the side of the foot there, and we'll see what happened.
You had a smile on your face after it hit you. We didn't think it was serious.
I had a fool Tony.
Yeah. Well, the Minnesota fans will be eager to find out if it's all right. Let's go back to Jack and Tim.
And we're rooting for Jack Morris, and of course you Twins fans are crossing your fingers. And another jam job and another foul ball, 1-2 to Alomar.
How about that? The reason he smiled was he wanted to fool Tony La Russa, the manager.
And stay in the game.
And stay in the ball game. I guess he fooled him. What, another inning and a third?
And he did pretty well, two innings. He did give up four hits, but only one run. Two balls, two strikes. First, Roberto at the plate, and at Sandberg, he had to flinch, might have gotten in the lights. The inning is over. 3-2 America.
My grandfather loved the unknown. I want a sure thing. I drive a new kind of Oldsmobile, the all-new Bravada, perfect for this jungle, because it's got Smart Trap, a new anti-lock braking and all-wheel drive system that automatically sends power to the wheel that needs it. So I'm ready for the unexpected, whether I'm traveling across the river and into the trees,
or just visiting your old man in the sea.
Bravada, engineered for the unexpected. When you've got a tough case of athlete's foot, the itching, the cracking, the burning, you want a medicine that acts tough. Tough Actin Tenactin. Clinically proven Tenactin cures even the tough cases of athlete's foot fungus. Get Tough Actin Tenactin.
Where do you want to be in 5 years?
I had an old Studebaker truck and $300 when I started this company.
In a few years, my sons will be ready to take over, and then I'd like to...
I never told anybody this. I want to live in Paris and go to cooking school. Hey, that's what I want to do. Will I have the money to do it?
You can get there from here with Shearson Lehman Brothers.
CBS Sports presents the 62nd All-Star Game from Toronto, brought to you by Oldsmobile, the new generation of Olds. Shearson Lehman Brothers, you can get there from here. And by the people at Nike who encourage you to just do it.
3-2 American League after four. Ozzie Smith will lead it off, and his mother remembers his young baseball days.
He would always wait for me to come home from work. And sometimes I wouldn't get a chance to wash his uniform. So I had to rush home, wash his uniform, press it, and take it over to the park to him, because we were living right across the street from the park. And he'd be waiting on that uniform.
Oh, that's nice.
And the Smith family raised a real gentleman. Strike one. We have a White Sox battery. Jack McDowell is on the mound with a 10-4 record. And his catcher is Carlton Fisk. And the pitch inside, 1-1. Ozzie lined out to short his first time. Two balls and a strike. He hasn't lost much at shortstop. The arm not as strong as he used to be, but he is compensated with knowledge of how to play the position. Got those little Popeye muscles, and he's hitting over 300. And he hits it foul, 2-2. I saw him a few years ago in spring training, Tim, and he was just killing himself. I said, what are you doing? He said, I'm going to play for a long time, and I better get ready now.
Some guys wait until it's too late, not Ozzie.
He's leading off here in the fifth. And ball three. I hate to see this game move along to the middle innings. It's so much fun, really. Wish we could play here all night long. Waiting on deck, Tony Gwynn, who's already had a hit. And Ozzie draws a walk. There's the tying run.
See that inside pitch to Ozzie Smith, and you think of the Johnny La Russa and the Carlton Fisk problems. Carlton Fisk was the catcher when Terry Steinbach, the catcher of the Oakland Athletics, was, eerily, scarily hit by Bobby Thigpen, the reliever. And he and La Russa had words. We talk about how comfortable it is for everybody to be here. Well, there can be some awkward moments also. Here you are playing for a manager. Just 3 weeks ago, you've had words with him. Jack McDowell, on the other hand, the pitcher, booed here earlier when the players were introduced, because back on May 19th, he hit the Toronto outfielder, Mark Whitten.
Tony Gwynn hits it foul and out of play. One strike.
Whitten went out to the mound. A fight ensued, and both Whitten and McDowell kicked out of the game, and he was booed tonight. So there you have a battery with a little controversy, and I would imagine between Pudge and McDowell, it's some awkward moments in that clubhouse.
But La Russa is rooting for McDowell here as he faces Tony Gwynn. Leadoff man is on. And a bouncer might be two. Got one. Nice play by Boggs to get that one started. And Alomar can make the double play.
Oh, baby. I'm telling you. Boggs on his knees, and watch Alomar. There are several ways you can protect yourself at second base. And watch Alomar use the bag right there. See, the bag's between him and the sliding Ozzie Smith. He made the quick pivot and helped Ozzie up. Pretty good athletic ability right there. Also, nice play by Wade Boggs on the front end.
And he helped McDowell out. They're two gone, and Sandberg bats with the bases empty. That's in at the knees.
There's that pivot. Once again, you see Alomar getting down, making Ozzie Smith get down. That's why you throw, not overhanded, but sidearm.
Sandberg drills one into right center field, and it is caught by Henderson. Dave, that is. Now we play 4.5. The American League leads by one.
One, two, three, four! This is ridiculous. I'm an athlete, not an actor.
Let me out of this thing.
I got rehab to do.
Well,
give me those shoes.
Oh.
Excuse me.
Nice shoes.
Watch too much TV, kid. You know I don't have time for this. But I do. Hit it.
Josh Jones has got that air thing.
Josh Jones. He got me into trouble more times than I could count. But what a friend's for. Times it was a joker, he played me for a fool. But what are friends for? Well, I remember once he stole my.
These men have been selected to write a page in military history. They are the best the Navy and Air Force have to offer. Charlie Sheen.
Seems no matter what I do, I end up hurting someone.
Lloyd Bridges. Call them the best of the best.
You're the best of the best.
Call them Hot Shots, the mother of all movies. This film is not yet rated. Starts Wednesday, July 31st at theaters everywhere.
You favor the use of instant replay as an officiating tool in sports? You can register your vote by calling this AT&T MultiQuest 900 service number. 1-900-436-9000. Each call will cost 95 cents. You must be 18 years or older to vote. You'll have the chance to vote on four different sports.
The Cal Ripken home run has the American League on top. 3-2, bottom of the fifth. And a new pitcher for the Nationals. It's Frank Viola of the Mets talking with Benito. We have a new shortstop. It's Barry Larkin. And a new second baseman having a terrific year for the Dodgers, Juan Samuel. And here the big ovation for Joe Carter, who's going to lead it off his first at bat tonight. Fifth. Missed outside. Frank 10-5. And he's the third pitcher of the night for the National League. He held up. And that's ball two. Swing. And Carter is hitting 302.
That was a changeup from Frank Viola at circle change, taught to him by Johnny Podres, the pitching coach of the Phillies now in the minor leagues with Frank when Frank was with Minnesota.
And 3-1 to the leadoff man. Challenge him, Frank. See what happens here. He caught the corner. Carter didn't think so, and gets the crowd on the neck of the umpire.
That's one of those times when you can't really quibble about that strike because you want to hit anyway.
That's right. You don't want to walk. You don't want to walk, Joe.
No.
Ball into short right. That's trouble for Felix Jose, and it is a foul ball. Foul ball. Carter gets another crack at it. Take a look from up high, and you can umpire for yourself.
About a half a foot.
Greg Bonet, the umpire out there. By the way, these umpires are selected on merit. Once again, they changed the system, but now they are selected in that fashion. Carter with Cleveland, San Diego, now Toronto. Still 3-2 as he leads off in the fifth.
That was the big trade
Joe Carter and Roberto Alomar coming from San Diego for Fred McGriff and Tony Fernandez. Both Fernandez and McGriff having good years, helping out San Diego. And again, I think Fred McGriff should have been an all-star this year.
Everybody's happy about that trade. Another foul by Joe.
The all-star roster, you may or may not know, 28 players. And when they had eight teams in baseball before the 1961 season, it was a 25-man roster. So the American League has expanded by six teams since then and only added three players. The National League, four teams, and has added three players. And I think that's good enough reason to expand the rosters.
Carter strikes out on a low corner foul tip. So he's battling Viola. Here are some of the guys who did not make the team.
Yeah, Chuck Finley having a terrific year with California. What about a revived and rejuvenated Dave Winfield? The same with Chili Davis. Jose Canseco, of all people, 21 home runs. Brian Harper batting over 300, and we mentioned Fred McGriff.
And another foul. I might add to that list, there are others. Tom Pagnozzi, the St. Louis catcher, one of the big reasons for the St. Louis success this year. And to my mind, second only to Santiago, if he is second to Santiago as a catcher. We'll see what's going to come of this battle, Viola and Carter. And Carter wins the battle with a leadoff walk here in the fifth inning. We've all been asking all around here, where's Pat O'Brien? Where's Pat O'Brien?
I don't know.
Well, Jack, to be honest with you, I'm about 15 stories above right field at the Hard Rock Cafe. There's no baseball memorabilia up here. It's all rock and roll. For example, Michael Jackson's hat and shoes. Great glove, a lot of hits. Sorry about that. Anyway, it's all rock and roll. But the attraction here is, of course, a beautiful view of the baseball field, and I was trying to think of a cute and funny way to end this, but I can't. I guess I'm between a place and a Hard Rock.
A place and a Hard Rock, and we just saw a brilliant play by Tony Gwynn playing center field to take care of Wade Boggs.
Well, Tony Gwynn wasn't between a place and a Hard Rock. This ball, a fastball out over the plate, and Boggs hits it hard to the left of Tony Gwynn, and Gwynn makes a fine backhanded play. One out here in the fifth inning.
Boggs doesn't usually hit the ball out there, does
no,
he?
No, not against left-handers especially. That left field slot. Place in a Hard Rock.
That's O'Brien. I wonder where he's headed now. The batter is Ripken, star of the game so far, probably. Base hit, three-run homer. And a strike.
A lot of bad hops up in that Hard Rock Cafe. Only ballpark in Major League Baseball with a cafe that is as well known as the Hard Rock Cafe.
Let's see what Cal Ripken does this time. Double play ball, Larkin, Samuel, and that takes care of five. He dropped the ball. Clark, hey, Will, what are you doing? No error. Fielder's choice. Well, if you don't get a double play on that, you'll never get a double play.
Yeah, and you can't anticipate a double play, but if you could, this would be the ball on which you would anticipate it. Maybe there, where there's a will, there's not a way. Usually, Will sucks that ball up.
It looked like Samuel threw a little sidearm, and the ball must have sailed.
Yep. Samuel trying to make the runner, Joe Carter, get down. He did, but that ball did sail on Will Clark. That was an errant throw. That was not Clark's fault.
Yeah, the camera had a better angle than we did. Cecil Fielder is up. Two up. Ball one. Ripken playing it very close to first base. He can steal a base, but he's going to let Fielder swing the bat. This is a bonus at bat for the American League. And they're already ahead, 3-2, fifth inning. Smashed it in the left center, and Gwynn makes another good play, and the inning is over. 3-2 after five, American will return to the SkyDome after this message and a word from your local station.
Everybody remembers great comedy teams like Laurel and Hardy or Abbott and Costello. But who remembers Morton and Hayes? No one.
Premieres July 24th.
If he had not gone to Vietnam, I do not think that he would have shot the guy.
Gunned down in cold blood. Was it manslaughter or madness? Verdict, then. From the producers of Rescue 911. Extraordinary mysteries solved by ordinary people.
I was completely shocked.
Gregory Harrison hosts True Detectives, following Verdict, Friday.
This is CBS.
Yo, Fab Five Freddy with Billy D. Williams.
Yeah.
Nothing to fly is acting in the business, but Billy, what do you do to max and relax?
Well, Freddy, I usually like to spend a quiet evening at home with a few friends and Colt 45.
Yeah, I can dig that.
Oh, yeah.
Nothing like a smooth, ice-cold Colt 45.
As a matter of fact, I have some friends waiting for me at home right now.
Billy, you sure you don't need me to come with you?
Tonight on Channel 10 News.
Will the Phillies be playing in Philadelphia after their lease is up? Phillies President Bill Giles is playing hardball with the city over control of the Vet. Baseball memorabilia, it's a billion-dollar business. And tonight, in a Channel 10 News special report, Herb Denneberg tells you if your collection's items are all-star qualities or phonies. Also, you may think you're burning off big calories while you work out, but that may not always be the case. And he was a star for Temple. Can he make it with the Eagles tonight on the Channel 10 News after the game?
As cars get older, they may need higher and higher octane to perform like they used to.
But there is a gasoline specially formulated to control this higher octane need while providing the highest level of engine cleanliness. Texaco System 3!
You'll get great performance in every octane grade.
Still think all gasolines are the same?
Phillies owner playing hardball with the city. Channel 10 News after the game tonight.
We have a 3-2 score with the American League on top. The Cal Ripken home run. National League has out hit him 6-5. And this big crowd wondered what was happening here a moment ago. I'll show you what we're talking about. Jack McDowell ready to pitch. A big long limo, a stretch limo came on the field. And what happened? The ground crew jumped out wearing dinner jackets. And then Griffey and Henderson jumped in the car and said, take us away. But they're still in the lineup. And McDowell pitches to Will Clark. Ball one, ball two. Clark has a single and two trips. Second inning of work for the White Sox hurler.
That's doing it in style, and they have done it in style with SkyDome up here in Toronto.
Clark didn't want that one either, 3-0.
The roof was closed until 7:40 this evening, and it took about 20 minutes to open the roof. And unbelievably, it cost $7 to open this roof. Can you believe that? Whatever happened to inflation? $7 to open that roof.
And we're blessed.
It doesn't matter whether it's Canadian or American either.
No, and we're blessed with a beautiful evening here with very temperate weather.
That's cheap electricity.
Clark draws a walk, and here's Jim Cott. Jim?
I'm with the Wizard of Oz. 11 straight All-Star games. What's special about coming to this place?
I tell you what, you hear a lot about, a lot of people talk about the dome and the beauty of it and what a spectacle. And I tell you, it's breathtaking to see this place. There's so much information going on at one time. It's just a beautiful place.
Another thing that's going on are the St. Louis Cardinals. What's with your ball club this year? It's not just the kids, it's you veterans.
Well, we're all pitching in. Everybody is working very hard. Everybody's doing what they're capable of doing. And things have gone well to this point.
They sure have. Keep doing it, Oz.
Those two former teammates at St. Louis, and Bobby Bonilla gets his second hit of the night.
Bobby Bonilla in the first inning hit one off the foot of Jack Morris, and this was another base hit up the middle. You mentioned last year of his contract, Bobby Bonilla, and controversy as to whether Pittsburgh can maintain his salary. They've offered him $16 million for 4 years, and he turned it down. Right. Frank Viola, $13 million from the Mets for 3 years, turned down.
Well, here is the free swinging Felix Jose with the first two on in the sixth inning for the National League. Jack McDowell is in trouble. Felix hits one that's going to advance the runners, one of them at least, force out, no other play. Let's go down to the National League dugout from a moment ago with Lou Piniella talking with Jim Leland and Art Howell.
In other words, if we go 1, 2, 3,
you're not ready to go in?
What do you think?
You know, we could do. I'll tell you what we could do, though. If we want, is let Clark hit, right? We can hit Murray here in the DH spot and put Clark at first base.
Well, we'll see what they do. One of the things they're going to do is send up Paul O'Neill to bat for Ivan Calderon, the Cincinnati hitter. First and third, one out, and even a fly ball would tie this game in the sixth inning. Oh, and Felix is safe. He got back. That's the closest I've ever seen that play come.
Me too. I was thinking the same thing. Usually that play doesn't work at all, but Jack McDowell appearing to throw to third. Remember, you can fake to third when you're in the stretch. You can fake to second when you're in the stretch. However, you can't fake to first, so he fakes to third, wheels off the rubber, and throws back to first, and somehow Jose avoided the tag.
And he got the good call from John McSherry, not the automatic call. First and third, infielders back looking for two. And strike one to Paul O'Neill. O'Neill having another fine year for the Reds. He's backed up 0-2. The runner at third base is Will Clark. He started with a walk. On a fielder's choice is Felix Jose. And there is one out. O'Neill has 15 home runs. Only got one swing left. 1-2. All-star pitchers, and most of them are capable of striking batters out. Very few finesse pitchers. First and third, one out, a critical spot for the National League here in the sixth. Waiting on deck is Hojo. Soon to be a daddy. Howard Johnson of the Mets. 63 runs batted in. O'Neill laid off. 2-2. When the new baby arrives in the Johnson family, it'll be the third child. Val trying to keep that ball down, hopeful of getting the double play, and there's Hojo. Wanting to get up in an RBI situation. Well, they're going, and a bouncing ball. The play at the plate. Out at the plate is Will Clark, and the American League still leads 3-2. The hard slide of Clark didn't bother Fisk at all.
That's the toughest play for a catcher to make. The receiver throw from the right side of the field, and then turn around. You don't know where the runner is. But Fisk realized that he had some time, and he held on to the ball easily. You try to get the ball in your bare hand there, but Fisk didn't have time, so he had to make the tag with a glove hand, and the new catcher's mitts with the break in are more conducive to making that slap tag.
And that's typical of Will Clark with an hard slide.
Oh, sure.
He'll do
good.
It forever. Now they're two on, two out for Hojo. The American League still leads. National League needs a hit. Call one.
if you're the catcher and you receive a ball from the right side of the field, you don't know whether the runner is there, but I would imagine Fisk, knowing the speed of Clark and the ball getting to fielder rather quickly, he knew he had some time. A hard slide by Clark, but a scoring opportunity for the time being nullified by the National League.
Two on, two out. Johnson, ball on a half swing, one and one.
Coming into this game, Jack, Howard Johnson was the only National League non-pitcher with an RBI in all-star competition. Nobody else had an RBI. Of course, that's changed with the Dawson home run and the single by Bobby Bonilla in the first.
One ball, one strike. Strike two, one ball, two strikes. Ojo, a better hitter from the left side as he is batting now. Dowell gave up a walk and a single at the outset of the inning. He's still at first and second, two out. Play for Boggs. Two left for the Nationals. They've left five. They still trail by one.
It's stuck. You see?
Yeah.
Every channel. Light beer. Light beer.
Well, we're gonna have to drain it.
Grab anything that'll hold beer. Oh, and call some friends over.
Will you look at that?
Yeah, I'm looking.
Miller Lite made beer better.
The great Pilsner taste keeps you ahead of it all.
Everybody likes that.
You don't say beer now, you say light.
The beer that beers become.
Miller Lite.
It's it.
And that's that.
Someone who prefers the view from your couch, then never mind. The Toyota 4x4 for those other guys.
Yo, Mars Blackman here at NBA Finals. See what makes Michael Jordan the best.
Is it the shoes?
It had to be the shoes.
Power. Suspense. Drama. Baseball is many things, but in the end, baseball is nothing without you.
So we're asking you to plan ahead by choosing a designated driver who won't drink during the game. That way, everybody has a good time and you get home safely. And that matters to us because we can't do it without you.
The preceding message was furnished by Major League Baseball.
American League coming to bat in the sixth inning, leading 3-2, though they've been out hit 7-5. We have a new pitcher for the National League. And a fellow who is probably more thrilled than anybody to be on this all-star roster, Pete Harnisch of the Houston Astros. New first baseman from the Dodgers, Eddie Murray. Over at third base, Howard Johnson, who pinch hit and fouled out and left those men on base. Another unsuccessful pinch hitter was Paul O'Neill. He takes over in left field and he'll get another at bat. Tim, you saw more than I the bubbly reaction about Pete Harnisch being here.
Well, you were in Washington yesterday. By the way, Harold Baines, the pinch hitter for Danny Tartable. But you know, Harnisch has a record as a starter, like a reliever, to make an all-star team. He's 5-7. But think about how deceptive it is when you consider the fact that Harnisch has been involved in
six, a half dozen, 1-0 games. He's 2-2-2 in 1-0 games.
Harold Baines breaks the bat and grounds out to Samwell. I guess he got jammed, huh?
I would say that's a big league jam job right there.
So Harold Baines goes down on one pitch, and Harnish has some early success here in the sixth inning. Here's a strong hitter, Ruben Sierra of the Rangers, coming up to bat for Dave Henderson. Henderson 0 for 2. They have a good hitting lineup with the Rangers this year.
We talked about it earlier. Julio Franco, Sierra, Rafael Palmeiro, Steve Buschel having a fine year. Juan Gonzalez. They can put some thunder. If they can get people out, if Nolan Ryan can stay off the DL, they have as good a shot as anybody to win that American League West. They're presently in first place by percentage points over the Twins. But 2.5 games separates 5 teams in the American League West.
Nobody knows. Nobody knows. Nice to have somebody different in the postseason. Followed by the batter, Sierra, 1-2. And waiting on deck, Ken Griffey, who's already had a hit in this game. Griffey Jr. Leadoff man has been retired. Here in the sixth. 1-2 the count. Half swing and a foul ball. Eddie Murray, there's a guy who plays the game easily. I mean, easily. He's terrific offensively and defensively.
He has put up some numbers.
Hall of Fame numbers.
9 home runs shy of the 400 mark. I'll tell you, the guy batting right now, Ruben Sierra, you talk about numbers, second in the MVP voting 2 years ago to Robin Yount. And a lot of people thought he should have won the MVP that year, including Ruben Sierra. He's out to prove it again this year.
That breaking ball missed, 2-2. Number 21 in his ear.
Roberto Clemente has been compared to number 21 with the Pirates for years from Puerto Rico.
Let's go down to Jim Cott. James?
Here with Frank Viola. The Mets are starting to play better, and why?
Well, I think basically what it comes down to is our starting staff is finally doing the job we're capable of doing. And I think that builds everybody's confidence up. And, you know, when you get the key hit in a situation like that, the starters take over, and then we have a Johnny Franco in the bullpen. So actually, all cylinders are going now. We're looking forward to the second half.
What do you have to do in the second half to catch Pittsburgh? Main thing.
Continue playing good fundamental baseball. That's playing the defense, getting the timely hitting, doing the little things necessary to win, and hopefully the starters stay healthy and do their job.
Been an all-star in a Twins uniform, a Mets uniform. You'd probably be in the game again next year, but what uniform will you be wearing?
We'll just have to wait till the end of the season, and we'll go from there, Kitty.
All right. How about Rod Carew, the honorary captain? You threw him his 3,000th hit. You remember that day?
Oh, yeah. I'm in the Hall of Fame for something.
Yeah
it was a slider down and away, and he patented Rod Carew. Popped it over to shortstop's head for a base hit, and I'll tell you what, I'm very honored to be able to say I gave up his 3,000th hit.
Don't blame you. Back to Jack and Tim.
2-2. And another foul from Ruben Sierra. This pitcher, Pete Harnish, born on Long Island, played baseball at Fordham University. Viola pitched one inning. Gave up a walk, but got away with it. Harnish has a 2-2 count. And another foul. Out in the American League bullpen, Jeff Reardon is warming up. And for the National League, the Pittsburgh left-hander, John Smiley. Lots of players have been in this contest. It's 3-2 American League sixth inning. And Sierra hits another foul. And nothing doing for Benito.
Remember?
mentioned 2 years ago the numbers that Sierra put up, and this year no exception. Ruben Sierra still 25 years old. Think about the future he has ahead of him. Third in the American League in hitting. Top five, all of them are here tonight.
There is one out, and Sierra continues this battle with Pete Harnisch. 3-2. Popcorn, popcorn.
Yeah.
Even shape climbing all those steps. That's a beautiful ballpark. This is a perfect ballpark. People in Toronto have been quite hospitable. Did he swing? Third base umpire said yes, and out he's gone. Jim Quick made the call. Sierra can't believe it. I think he swung. That's the second out of the inning. All-star game or no, a half swing's a half swing.
Yep, I thought he went around too. Yeah, that's too far, and Jim Quick called it quickly. A good battle by Sierra to battle Harnisch, fouling all those balls off, and Harnisch goes out of the strike zone to nail Sierra.
He was very emphatic with it. Ruben's still unhappy. He's only at bat. He struck out. And the batter is Ken Griffey Jr. What'd you tell me? His dad's out fishing?
Out fishing with his younger brother, who has recently signed with the Seattle Mariners.
There's two quick ones on Griffey.
Ken Griffey in the automobile accident in spring training. Injured, still on the disabled list, but still very much on the roster of the Seattle Mariners. First father and son players to ever play together.
Well, it's not going to be a perfect inning for Harnisch. He lost the batter on an 0-2 count. That's the sixth hit for the American League, and it comes with two out. Two hits for Griffey.
Junior didn't get all of it, but he got enough of it to push it through on the right side. Cal Ripken Jr. with two of the hits. Ken Griffey Jr. with two of the hits. So juniors have four of the six hits for the American League.
And look who's up. Isn't that great? Still playing so well. Alden Fisk.
43 years old.
Batting with two out. And ball one. Tell us about that number, Tim. That's 72. That's unusual for a regular.
Rookie of the year back in 1972, and his number with the Red Sox was 27, so when he signed with the White Sox, the Pale Hose, he decided to turn it around. His son Casey born in the year 1972. He was a rookie of the year that year and thought he would turn his luck around. And as Steve Lines had that great line earlier this year that going from the White Sox to the Red Sox, he said it's time to change socks. Every 5 years, you got to change socks. So in Pudge's case, it was every 10 years, you got to change socks. From red to white.
One ball, one strike. So that's the story of the number. Runner at first, two out. Ball two.
Oldest all-star to get a hit with no surprise there, Ted Williams. Stan Musial, 3 months younger. Stan Musial, the leader in home runs in all-star history with six. Ted Williams tied with Fred Lynn. They both have four, and Fred Lynn with the only all-star Grand Slam homer off Atlee Hammaker in 1983.
So Fisk would break that record if he gets a hit. Runner going. And a foul, 2-2. From high above, the shot from the Fuji blimp. Being piloted tonight by the senior captain and chief of operations, John McHugh. He's flown blimps all over the world, and he's up above the Toronto picture tonight. You folks get a chance, come to Toronto and see the SkyDome. It's worth the trip. And a wonderful city to boot. A little on the expensive side, the ball players who play here tell me, but where isn't it? Two balls. balls, two strikes, the count to Fisk.
You can open the roof for $7. That's not high. The roof is, but the price isn't.
That ball, it might drop. It does. Gwynn broke back. He is the oldest man to ever get a hit in an All-Star game. Carlton Fisk. Nice going, Pudge. Good for you.
You just moved to the top of the list.
Yes, sir. Give me a hand, folks.
That's great.
I'm applauding myself. That's terrific. Tony Gwynn helped him out a little bit by breaking back on the ball, but what the heck. First and third, two out against Harnish. Looked like it was going to be an easy inning, and now Roberto could burn him. American League already leading 3-2, sixth inning. Out of play. Griffey at third base. He singled his way on and across the way. The older guy.
Pudge, 21 years older than Ken Griffey Jr.
That sounds strange. That sounds strange. Quite a tribute to his work habits. And Roberto takes it high, 1-1. This place would erupt if Alomar would get a hit. And La Russa, the manager, would like a little more leeway. Bottom of the sixth, 3-2 Americans. Two out and a shot for Gwynn to corral. He'll take it. American leaves two. They've left six, but they lead by one after six.
We ask pasta lovers in Italian neighborhoods to try new microwave main meals from Chef Boyardee.
These are absolutely good. Absolutely. It's delizioso.
Hey, Frank, try a little more. The more you put them out, the better the taste.
Got tomato.
Got meat. A little onion in here. Very good.
Well, you put onion in it.
You have to put onion in it. What's the matter with you?
Very delicious.
But my wife's comes first.
I'm surprised. It's Chef Boyardee.
New main meals from Chef Boyardee. Simply Italian. Simply terrific.
Very close to Italian.
It's a rare species that thrives like no other. Easily distinguished by unique markings, lean and powerful, adapting quickly to changing environments, it migrates to the snows in winter and has been spotted as far south as Baja. It prefers wide open spaces, primary instinct to care for its young. The Toyota 4Runner. No matter how distant the journey, it always returns home.
We all like to keep our car looking new. That's why so many people use Armor All Protectant. Armor All cleans and shines the rubber, plastic, and vinyl. And it protects all those surfaces, too. So Armor All makes your car look like new. And helps it last longer. And that makes you look pretty smart. Armor All, it keeps you looking good.
Now treat your whole car with the complete line of Armor All products.
Sunday, they're young and very restless. The up-and-coming Yankees take on ex-teammate Dave Winfield and the Angels. Baseball's biggest moments are on CBS.
Welcome back to Toronto, Ontario. A breathtaking view of the SkyDome. American League leads 3-2 in the ball game. When we talked about the eating arrangements here, how about the sleeping arrangements? There are 70 rooms that face the ballpark. This one taken by the Opeachy Company. They are sort of the tops of Canada. I am in the upstairs bedroom. In fact, they even have a Jack Buck card. Jack, I'll bring this to you later. But the room is like any other room, except when they say room with a view, folks, they mean room with a view. For $1,000 a night, they get this kind of thing. The bed's a little small, but it's comfortable. And fellas, there's a great, as a matter of fact, when you get up from this bed, you say, what a great day for baseball as you look out for this. But fellas, there's a story about a couple who were very amorous on one of these beds, but I'll leave that for you to tell.
You leave it for me to tell? Back to Pat O'Brien. Well, we have some changes. Jeff Reardon is the new pitcher in the fifth of the night for the American League. His first opponent is Benito Santiago, and a bouncer to second. Alomar throws out his former teammate, and there's one gone. We have a new left fielder. Joe Carter was in the game earlier. Center fielder is a newcomer to this game, Kirby Puckett. How can you keep him off an all-star team? And we also have a new right fielder, Ruben Sierra, who pinch hit. We're in the seventh inning. It's getting late for the National League, and their batter is Barry Larkin, hitting for the first time. Tell you the Jack McDowell, two innings, no runs, one hit, no strikeouts, walk two. But those men were left on. Larkin hits a foul, strike two.
Barry Larkin leading the National League in slugging percentage. Only five shortstops have ever done that in National League history. He also recently had three home runs in one game. Only Ernie Banks and Freddie Patek, diminutive Freddie Patek, had three home runs at Fenway Park in Boston one night.
Hard hit to Ripken. That's a second out. Jim Cott, take it away.
Oh, Will Clark, all-star games are fun. Most of all, just being here is more so than play. What's special about coming to this place?
Well, this is an excellent ballpark, and the fans are great. And so far, we've had a good time just being here for the last 2 days. And I tip my cap to the city of Toronto. They've done a great job welcoming the ballplayers, and the ballplayers are responding with some great baseball.
Has to be a disappointing season for the Giants so far. What can we look for in the second half for improvement?
Well, we're finally starting to get some people healthy, and Kevin Mitchell's back in the lineup, so you're going to see a lot more run production.
Well, congratulations. Back to Jack and Tim.
Thank you. And Will Clark, while he was in the game, had a base hit and a walk. And he gave way to Eddie Murray. This is Tony Gwynn. He is 1-for-3. And now another hit. Typical of him. He's 2-for-4. And a two-out hit gives the National League a seventh-inning chance.
Tony Gwynn with two hits to left field. He uses all of the park in which to hit. You can see that plate coverage. That ball was actually outside by about 3 inches. That was a great shot right there. And Gwynn with that terrific plate coverage is now out of there. And Brett Butler is going to be the pinch runner for Tony, who leaves the game 2-for-4.
So we have a definite base-stealing threat in Butler, who comes into the game here in the seventh inning. Will take over in center field. Butler has stolen 19 bases. Ho, 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 he's been thrown out 14 times. Not a very good percentage, and pitcher and catcher want to talk it over.
I think it's worth another shot just to see the plate coverage of Tony Gwynn. Look where the pitch is. Probably 5 inches outside, and Tony Gwynn just spanks it to left field. Wow. What a hitter.
Ben Williams was talking about not swinging at bad pitches. He said you swing at a pitch 2 inches outside, 2 inches inside, 2 inches high, 2 inches low, and you've expanded the strike zone by 30%. Sunday, Yankees and California will tangle. Pre-game at 2:30 Eastern Time, and you'll hear more of the conversation with Ted Williams and Joe DiMaggio. Tony La Russa comes out to talk with Reardon and his catcher. Reardon says, go ahead, let him steal, I'll get the next guy. Eight hits for the National League, 7 for the American. Now we're going to have a pitching change. We'll be back.
Where do you want to be in 20 years?
Well, my father worked for the same company for 39 years. He got 2 weeks vacation, but we never traveled far. He was saving to put 3 kids through college. At 65, he retired. At 67, he died. How can I invest so that after my kids graduate, I can enjoy the second half of my life?
You can get there from here with Shearson Lehman Brothers.
If you're looking into faucets, Peerless means plenty. America's leading do-it-yourself faucet. In hundreds of styles and finishes, all made with solid brass valve construction, and all warranted for as long as you own your home. The best made, best backed, do-it-yourself faucets in America. That's what Peerless means.
Some people think he's a Superman, but when a 44-year-old has to throw 75 fastballs, even Nolan Ryan's muscles can ache. So after the game, it's the medicine doctors recommend most for sprains and strains, Advil.
For me, it's a couple of Advil, and those muscle aches are long gone. And Advil's gentler on my stomach than aspirin.
Today, it isn't aspirin or Tylenol acetaminophen. It's Advil.
I feel ready to go another 9 innings.
Advil. Tablets and caplets. Advanced medicine for pain.
Donnie Allison, Cal Yarborough, and 20 other NASCAR legends take to the track for a race down memory lane. The Battle of the NASCAR Legends, Saturday.
Eye on America's prisons. They're coming out. Parolees who've served just a fraction of their sentences, and guess where they're going? The story on the CBS Evening News tomorrow.
The new pitcher is Rick Aguilera. Playing third base behind him is Wade Boggs. CBS visited with his dad a few days ago.
I can remember back when I was coaching in Little League, and he had an old owl foot on a string that he wore around his neck, and it was his good luck charm. One day somebody sold his owl foot. Well, Wade, he went berserk. You know, no owl foot, no hips. For the next year, I hunted owls all over the state of Florida. I'm trying to find an owl to shoot to get him another owl foot.
There's Wade Boggs. I wonder if he still wears an owl's foot around his neck.
Oh, very unusual for Wade Boggs to be superstitious, right? He goes out, he runs at 517, or takes ground balls at 517 every night. He runs at 717 every night on a 735 start, and he eats chicken before every game. Everybody knows about the superstitions of Wade Boggs.
What time does he eat?
I don't know. I guess 317.
Aguilera pitching to Samwell, who gets a two-out hit to continue this National League threat in the seventh inning. First pitch from Aguilera, base hit past the owl foot. Rick Aguilera has 22 saves for the Twins, one less than Dennis Eckersley, who leads the American League. And Tim, you and I saw him when he was struggling as a starter. He finally found a home.
Starter with the New York Mets, traded in June of 1989. Along with left-hander David West, Kevin Tappany doing a fine job with Minnesota. Tim Drummond also in that trade. I tell you, it's interesting as you see Eddie Murray right there. Aguilera throwing a lot of fastballs and sliders before the 89 season. He was jogging along the beach in California. He's from California. He saw a softball on the side. He picked the softball up, and he said, you know what, I think I'll stretch my fingers out and learn how to throw the split finger fastball. Well, that softball was a blessing in disguise, because now he's one of the top short relievers in baseball.
He better do the job here against Eddie Murray. Two on, two out, and a foul out of play. Jim Cott, what do you have for us?
Well, you see a lot of smiles at All-Star time, none bigger than the one on the face of Dave Henderson, your first time. Everything is cracked up to be?
Oh, yeah. I'm glad to be here and see the guys, and had a lot of fun.
Do you feel uncomfortable in the dugout the first time? Because there's a lot of players that, when the season starts in the second half, you don't like anymore.
Oh, yeah, and they're all AL West guys, and we got to beat them up, so they're looking at us kind of funny.
That's a great race, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, it's going to be fun down the stretch.
All right, back to the action.
Two on, two out. And low to Murray. One ball, one strike. And that was Aguilera's best pitch, Tim.
And that's the splitter we were talking about. Stretched those fingers out with that softball, and now he throws that splitter about as easily as he does his fastball.
Eddie Murray, one of the big reasons why the Dodgers lead by five over Cincinnati. And that's a strike, one and two.
Splitter, it's just tough to gauge if you're a hitter. You see the downward action, the ball almost coming back also. Very, very unusual pitch, and as we said earlier, the pitch of the 90s.
That was a dangerous delivery there, but Aguilera got away with it, and he's ahead on the count. And he struck him out. Fisk dropped the ball, tagged him. Now the National League has left seven, and they still trail 3-2, seventh inning.
Toyota presents All Around Champions. Ken Griffey Jr., the Seattle Mariners' flashy center fielder, is a Gold Glove Award winner and two-time All-Star. Off the field, Griffey's also an All-Star, a supporter both financially and personally of the Children's Hospital and Medical Center of Seattle. Toyota is proud to contribute $1,000 to the Children's Hospital. Toyota salutes all-around champions.
We think you'll like the new 1992 Toyota Paseo so much, we don't have to use cheap advertising tricks to plan your emotions. So you won't see any young models in bikinis, no radical cornering maneuvers, no smoking tires, not even a low price as a come-on. So there's no pressure. Think it over. Thank you. The all-new Paseo, a very practical car from Toyota.
Brace yourself. The summer movie has arrived.
Trust me.
An incredible trip. Arnold Schwarzenegger is superb. Arnold Schwarzenegger, Terminator 2, Judgment Day, rated R. Now playing at a theater near you.
A Motorcraft spark plug has to fire 500 times a minute. Over its life, that's a spark 5 miles long. Shouldn't you install that peace of mind? Motorcraft quality parts from Ford.
Miller Lite would like to translate the sounds guys make when watching baseball.
The great Pilsner taste keeps you ahead of it all.
Can't be that.
Miller Lite.
It's it.
And that's that.
The race is on to make batteries that last longer. And today's Duracell batteries can even outrun the ones we made just a few years ago. Today's Duracell. You can't top the copper top.
The situation we talked about. Delay a little bit. I want to get Aggie so we take a slow bit. Getting the lead. I stay in a bench, get your pom-poms, yell like hell.
CBS had a microphone on Tony La Russa. He said, stall a little bit. We'll get Aguilera in here. Sit on the bench and root during the seventh inning stretch. And that's where we are now, bottom of the seventh. And the new pitcher is John Smiley of the Pirates. And the first pitch, ball one. And the new catcher is Craig Biggio from Seton Hall and the Houston Astros. The batter is Joe Carter. And a foul out of play makes it 1-1. Out in center field after pinch running is Brett Butler. Pete Harnish pitched one inning. No runs, two hits, one strikeout, no walks. And Smiley is the fifth National League rookie. Pirate left-hander is 9-6 for the year. Carter has walked in his only plate appearance. And a base hit. They like that here in Toronto. And we're going to get a pinch hitter in a moment.
Carter walked his first time up, and then the inside breaking ball by John Smiley. And Joe has the seventh, make that the eighth hit for the American League, and his first hit in All-Star history. His first game tonight after 9 years in the major leagues. And I'm telling you, ringing up some big numbers in the process.
Good for him. His first hit. Here is the pinch hitter. Is due up, and it's Paul Molitor of Milwaukee. They don't pinch hit for Wade Boggs very often. And with a left-hander pitching, Russo sends up Molitor. One ball, one strike. Now 9 hits for the National League, 8 for the American, and Tony La Russa hanging on by 1 run, 7th inning. run and bunt play, and it's 1-2.
It looked like that was a missed sign.
Right.
And you can kind of understand that as you see Scott Sanderson warming up for the American League. I mean, the third base coaches try to keep the signs as simple as possible in these games, because obviously the player is very unfamiliar with the signs, but Molitor squaring around the bunt and Carter taking off, probably a missed sign.
Late swing and a foul by Molitor, and what?
Interference on the catcher.
Interference by Biggio. So that's an error charge to the catcher. And runners at first and second, nobody out.
Got to go back in the archives and find out when the last time that happened. It's the first time we are told that that has ever happened in All-Star history. Interference by the catcher. And that, to me, blows my mind.
First time ever.
First time ever. 62 All-Star games. And here it is, Craig Biggio. His first start, the only catcher who's ever started for Houston.
New pitcher coming in.
If you don't have AT&T 800 service and trouble hits, who knows how long you could be out? Only AT&T automatically protects you through the 800 assurance policy. With AT&T, you would be guaranteed back in touch in 30 minutes or less. With anyone else, who knows? But if you do have AT&T, your 800 service is guaranteed. That's not all. Since AT&T connects calls 25% faster and has the fewest blocked calls, more 800 calls get through, so you can make more sales. With all that, why choose any other 800 service? Better service, better results. Another AT&T advantage.
The driver of this car adds something special to his motor oil. So does the driver of this car. They both use STP oil treatment. For drivers on a racetrack or drivers on a fast track, STP.
Power Stick Antiperspirant. It excels with 50% more odor and wetness fighters per stroke for 24-hour control that ordinary deodorant sticks just can't beat. Power Stick for 24-hour control.
In America, your car is not just something you own. It's a part of your life. To give your car complete protection, Texaco is introducing new Haviland Formula 3 motor oil with not one but three kinds of protection against heat stress, starting friction, and engine dirt. New Haviland Formula 3. Add more life to your car.
When the batter makes contact with the catcher's mitt before the ball thrown, it's interference on the catcher, an error on the catcher, and this is the first time it's ever happened in All-Star history. You look at Molitor looking back at Joe Brinkman, and Molitor awarded first base, an error on Craig Biggio.
And no official time at bat for Molitor. The new pitcher is Rob Dibble. No wins, no losses. 23 saves. He and Lee Smith and Dennis Eckersley lead the major leagues in saves. And this guy has been perfect coming out of the bullpen for Cincinnati. We'll see some homers here. And we saw Biggio jabbing at the ball a bit as he was warming up Dibble. Ripken is out, and we're going to have a pinch hitter for him. Now, Ripken has a single and a three-run homer, and Ozzie Guillen will bat, and he might be bunting with nobody out. And it's tough to bunt Dibble. American League leading, 3-2, seventh inning. Let him swing. And the managers usually do in a game of this sort.
Yeah, right. There's no sense of coming to all, unless it's an extra inning game, a game-winning situation. They didn't come here to bunt.
Game one swing, and Dibble's play has to go to first. That was a fastball to first base, too. But Sam Well taking the throw. You can hear the ball smack into his glove. And this is when Cincinnati enjoys having Dibble in the game because he can strike people out.
Well, he did indeed sacrifice. So Ozzie Guillen finds shortstop for the White Sox. And he is buzzed out by Dibble. I mean, Dibble threw a seed to first base.
And we have another pinch hitter from the Texas Rangers. Rafael Palmeiro, and they're going to walk him. And they're going to make Dibble pitch with the base and loaded, one out. This will be the third walk issued to the American League tonight. While they're doing it, let's go down to Jim Cott.
Well, Jeff Reardon, second on the all-time list for career saves. You're used to finishing games, but you got some unusual orders when Tony La Russa came out there.
Yeah, when he came out, I was joking around, what should I do now? Because I'm not really used to coming out in the seventh inning, but I understand his move. You got to try to get all the relievers in there.
And he said, did you go to the bench and grab your pom-poms and cheer for Rick Aguilera?
That's what he told me to do, so I went there, and Rick got the big strikeout, so it was nice to see him do the job.
All right, back to Jack and Tim.
And as a result of that strikeout of Eddie Murray, the American League held on to the lead, and now they have a big threat going. Base is loaded, one out, bottom of the seventh, 3-2 American League. The runners are Joe Carter at third, down at second, Paul Molitor, and just given the walk, Rafael Palmeiro, and at the plate, Harold Baines. Second at bat. Oh, but I got a kick out of Baines cranking it up for that fastball.
You better turn a notch up, I'll tell you.
Watch his front foot. That's ball two.
Rob Dibble, the losing pitcher in last year's All-Star game. He gave up the two-run double to Julio Franco in the sixth inning at Wrigley Field.
And a line drive into right, and it is caught by Felix Jose. The throw is not in time. American League, and Chris are going to lead 4-2. Run charge to John Smiley, 4-2 Americans.
That was a good base running play by Joe Carter. Your inclination is to take a couple of steps toward home, but because the ball has no lift to it, you don't have much time to get back to third, and you could see Carter scamper back to third base and score rather easily.
So Dibble gives up the intentional walk, then the sacrifice fly. And he will pitch to Ruben Sierra after Carter scores. First and second, two out. I don't know where Felix Jose was throwing that ball. Ball one. You're not going to throw it home. You better throw it to third. If you don't throw it to third, you better throw it to second.
I think he was trying. A lot of times when an outfielder catches the ball, you don't get a good grip on it. You try to throw it too quickly. And I think that ball obviously missed the cutoff man, Eddie Murray. But I don't think he had a good grip on the ball across seams to throw it like he can.
Two balls, no strikes to a dangerous hitter, Ruben Sierra. They're doing trading card business here during the course of the game. Kid's got a good collection. Dibble blitzed it by him.
Here's that throw by Felix Jose, the right fielder. And when an outfielder throws it this far offline, you know he didn't have the proper grip on the ball, and Carter's allowed to score easily.
4-2 American League, seventh inning. And the foul makes it 2-2.
By the way, I'd like to correct that. Rob Dibble gave up the losing hit last year. He gave up the double to Franco, but the losing pitcher was Jeff Brantley of the Giants.
And as a result of that, the American League has won three in a row, and they're leading here in the seventh, 4-2. Two on, two out, two balls, two strikes. And the strikeout ends the inning, and now the American League has left eight, but they're on top by two.
Introducing the new 1992 Paseo from Toyota. It's a practical, sensible car.
Women dig it.
For people who know their limitations.
Let's party.
And can appreciate performance.
16 valves, 100 horsepower.
In moderation. So don't expect a lot of excitement.
It's a blast.
Just good, basic transportation.
Women dig it.
At a price we're too modest to mention.
Starting under 10 grand.
We think you'll probably like it.
You'll love it.
The all-new Paseo, a very practical car. From Toyota.
If your sporty car doesn't feel so sporty anymore, you need a change by the team, the BF Goodrich Tire Team. And right now, when they put on a set of four BF Goodrich TA tires, take advantage of this Major League offer. Get your choice of a Major League team jacket or pullover with your favorite team logo free. For a whole new level of performance and free sportswear, hustle into a participating BF Goodrich tire dealer today.
There's a feeling across this land. Every man and woman and child understands. It's a feeling you know and you never outgrow. Look around, it's right there to see.
Adios, amigo!
Only one man is crazy enough to pull a stunt like this. Only one man is crazy enough to go after it.
You pull the cord!
Patrick Swayze.
Now you pull it! 6 seconds!
Keanu Reeves.
Pull it!
Point Break, rated R. Starts Friday at theaters everywhere.
11:25 p.m. in Toronto, and not many people have left this game. 4-2, the American League on top. And I want to update you now on the results of our in-progress CBS AT&T viewer poll. The question was, do you favor the use of an instant replay as an officiating tool in sports? Here are the numbers. Baseball, 54% of you said yes. Basketball, 52%. Football, 69%. And golf, 35%. And remember, the lines were made open on this 1-900 number throughout this broadcast and until the end of the broadcast. And fellas, if you don't have time, I'll make the call for you. Back to you guys.
Thanks, Pat. You can make the call and vote against the instant replay in baseball for me. How about
me too,
Tim?
Same.
Here we go into the eighth inning, and time running short for the National League. They're down by two. Bonilla against Rick Aguilera. Eighth inning. Popped it up. And Ozzie Guillen, the new shortstop, wants it. Puckett stays away, and there's one out. The new first baseman for the American League is Rafael Palmeiro. You just saw Ozzie Guillen, the happy little imp. He just made the put out. And the new third baseman was the pinch hitter, Paul Molitor. Hello.
Look at that. He's peeking in.
Low TNA.
Little snow cone there, right?
Big swing by Felix Jose. Strike one. Felix is 0 for 1 in this game. We have good news about John Morris. Negative x-rays. John Morris has a contusion of the right foot after being struck by the batted ball by Bonilla. That led to the National League's first run. Their other run, a home run by Dawson, which should have counted for two. He hit it so far. Felix corks it through the hole, and it'll bring up the tying run. Here's Jim Cott once again.
Well, Jack and Tim, last year, about 100 points less in the batting average, half as many home runs, but Cal Ripken with the big three-run blow tonight. And let me see, it's about as simple as this. That was the change you made.
Flexing the knees, creating a little balance in the stance, letting the ball come to you.
And what's it enable you to do?
It enables me to wait on the ball and use your hands a little more. I was really, my body was getting in the way of my swing.
These things are old hat for you, but this is a time everybody smiles. Looks like you're having fun.
When you get a few hits and you hit a home run, it's time to smile. But We take it pretty seriously. We try to get this win here tonight, so until it's all over, we won't smile too much.
Yesterday was a lighthearted time. That was some kind of show you put on it, and you ripped all those balls. No cheapies.
No, I got into a rhythm, and I hit the balls good. Granted, it was carrying pretty good yesterday, but for the most part, I hit those very well.
Possibly the best player in all of baseball today. They say sometimes guys aren't as nice as they seem or as good as they seem. This guy is. Let's go back to the game.
And we have the tying run at the plate in the person of Paul O'Neill. Strike one to him. 1-1 with Felix Jose at first. One out. Eighth inning. American League on top. 4-2. By the way, Cal Ripken, in addition to a three-run homer, another base hit. Two out of three for the evening. He's through for the night. Low to O'Neill, who for a big hitter knows that strike zone extremely well. And Lou Piniella flashing signs to the third base coach, Sam Perlaza.
Doubtful anything's on here. I mean, I think the National League has to wait back for the two-run homer. If you're one run up, something may be on, but not two runs.
Jose the runner being held by Palmeiro. One out. Aguilera makes certain. Chicago, when Palmeiro was traded away, he continues to prove he's one of the best hitters in the game. He's playing first now. Oh, big swing by O'Neill. 2-2.
Now you mentioned another club, the Chicago Cubs. Let's take a look at the American League East. The Toronto Blue Jays ahead of Boston by 5.5 games. In the American League West, the Texas Rangers and the Minnesota Twins, surprisingly. And there are 5 teams in that division in the American League West. And the spread is 2.5 games. Man,
that's the way it ought to be. That's the way it is. Still 2-2 to O'Neill. O'Neill popped out. Felix Jose singled. His first All-Star hit. And a foul out of play.
In the National League in the second half, what can you look for? Well, the Pittsburgh Pirates, one time during the first half, the best team, I thought the best team in baseball. They're still a very, very good club. They're 2.5 games in front of the Mets, who have won 7 in a row, and the Cardinals are 5 games back. In the NL West, the Dodgers, 5 games back, and Cincinnati in second place. The Dodgers have opened up things for Tommy Lasorda with Oral Hershiser back healthy and Tim Belcher.
Well, they have good pitching. The Dodgers have good pitching, and the Mets are getting better pitching now. 2-2. Oh, he got him. With what, Tim?
That's that splitter we told you about. Aguilera with real long fingers, and if you can, we talked about the spread on them, and that gives the downward motion on that tumbling sinker. The splitter, you can see how much that ball goes down, and usually when hitters swing and miss at that pitch, they swing over the top of it. They think it's going to be a strike, and the bottom falls out at the last minute.
The two-out batter for the National League is Howard Johnson. Fouled out in his only at-bat. He could tie this game, and Aguilera works hard at keeping Felix Jose at first. Two-out, eighth inning. Johnson with a great RBI total. Look out back here. And that strike one to Howard. Johnson's driven in 63 runs for New York so far. And helped them on the recent surge to get within 2.5 for the Pirates.
Leads the National League in home runs, extra base hits, and RBIs.
And hits most of his home runs left-handed. Up and in, that's a lot of RBIs for the first half of the season. One ball, one strike.
But 40 RBIs shy of Hank Greenberg back in 1935. Now listen to this. He had 103 RBIs at the All-Star break, Hank Greenberg, and didn't make the All-Star team. 25 home runs, 103 RBIs, and the guy who chose him, his manager, was Mickey Cochran, who was also, you know, his manager.
And didn't pick him.
And didn't pick him. How about that? 103 RBIs at the All-Star break. Greenberg ended up that year with 170 RBIs.
Yeah, when I was chatting with Ted Williams and Joe DiMaggio last night, looking at those RBI figures, you know, 150, 160, amazing. 145. Hmm. 2-2 the count with two out. Followed by Johnson. He's the tying run at the plate in the eighth inning. Next year, the All-Star game will be in San Diego, another lovely city.
Roberto Alomar will tell you that. He played in San Diego, traded here to Toronto. Howard Johnson can hit that fastball away.
Fisk thought they had him struck out. Aguilera started to walk off the hill.
This ball right on the outside corner, and Fisk wanted it. Aguilera wanted it, but Joe Brinkman didn't call it.
Now the runner will go. Palmeiro at first plays behind Felix Jose. 3-2, two out.
Splitter here.
On 3-2, runner going, and he struck him out on that splitter in the dirt. That's what Fisk wanted, and that's what they got him with. 8 left for the National League. They still trail by 2, middle of the 8th.
Testing lasted 2 years and yielded new gasolines that are clearly advanced. Exxon announces Phase 4. New gasolines that give you the highest level of engine cleaning in every grade, that give you lower pollution for cleaner air, and a full measure of performance from every drop.
It's better.
Rely on Phase 4 from Exxon.
Been driving for nearly 2 decades. You've had your license renewed a number of times. Isn't it time you had your spirit renewed as well?
Breyer and Wilder.
Hello? Anybody home?
They're strange.
That actually feels good.
They're crazy.
I mean, you came. You touched me.
They're back.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Another You, rated R. Starts Friday, July 26th at a theater near you.
CBS Sports presents the 62nd All-Star Game from Toronto, brought to you by your Toyota dealers. Toyota, I love what you do for me. The people at Nike who encourage you to just do it. And by Miller High Life. Buy that man a Miller.
We have a 4-2 American League lead in the bottom of the eighth inning, although they've been out hit. Free swinging affair. Looking down from our Fuji blimp, and then close up to Mike Morgan, a 9-5 performer. for the first-place Dodgers.
And that in itself is unusual because Mike Morgan has never pitched in the big leagues or professional ball, really, and had a winning record.
The VIP box here at SkyDome. Commissioner Faye Vincent is there. And that's where President Bush was and Prime Minister Brian Mulroney. They are elsewhere at the moment.
Also, Ted Williams and Joe DiMaggio, which conjures up the Paul Simon song, Where Have You Gone, Joe DiMaggio? A nation turns its lonely eyes to you. Woo, woo, woo.
Why don't you sing it?
No, I can't.
I'll give you the pitch. Here's the pitch from Mike Morgan to Kirby Puckett, and that's a strike. Puckett batting for the first time this evening. One and one. Big three-run homer by Cal Ripken, the story of this game that occurred in the third inning. National League jumped on top with a run. Ripken's home run in the third. National League, Dawson home run in the fourth, 3-2. Insurance run in the seventh inning for the Americans, 4-2. Bucket of foul, 2-2. This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of Major League Baseball. It may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form without the express written consent of Major League Baseball. National League will have only one more crack at it. Larkin to Murray. And one gone in the home eighth. Barry Larkin, boy, the Reds missed him when he was out of the lineup.
Mm-hmm. And we mentioned his recent surge in power. Kirby Puckett, I'll tell you, I don't think anybody in baseball has as much fun playing the game than Kirby Puckett. Out early every day. He plays with Tom Kelly's son, as a matter of fact, when throws batting practice to him, and he's out at the on the field at 3 o'clock. Cannot get enough of baseball.
Carlton Fisk, the oldest player ever to catch in an All-Star game or get a base hit. That occurred here tonight. And he is one for one. Ball one. In the National League ninth inning, it's due to be Santiago, Larkin, and Butler. Morgan throws inside. Ball two.
Who will ever forget Carlton Fisk? 11th inning home run off Pat Darcy back in the 1975 World Series, Game 6 against the Reds. Reds won it in 7.
One of those unforgettable baseball moments. That's a strike, 2-1. Like the Williams home run in the All-Star game in Detroit, or the one against Rip Sewell on the old blooper pitch. People never forget those. And tonight, Cal Ripken made the highlight film of All-Star games with the home run. We'll be seeing that in the future. Maybe we'll show it to you next year from San Diego. 2-2 to Fisk. And a strikeout for Morgan. Those Minnesota Twins were picked for last in the American League West. They've been something to talk about. Chili Davis just murdering the baseball. He has 19 home runs, 52 RBIs. Scott Erickson has become the ace of the staff, although he's on the DL right now. And Tom Kelly, the manager, they trailed Texas by only a couple of percentage points. Big story. Maybe. Spins away from a Morgan pitch, 1-1.
Fastball inside by Mike Morgan, and you kind of wonder why Alomar's still in the game. Julio Franco, the only non-pitcher for the American League that hasn't played.
That'll take care of 8 innings in this one. We go to the ninth. The National League needs 2 runs.
After years of intense work, Lexus is ready to celebrate. Because even at the equivalent of 145 miles per hour, the Lexus LS400 is designed to stir the soul and not much else.
All across the USA, for as long as we've been around, our passengers are our neighbors. This country's our hometown.
Every time we fly, every mile of sky,
everything we do,
USA,
USA begins with you.
You know, Rust-Oleum Wood Saver trim paint is so moisture resistant, you paint your trim less often and have time for other things. Like playing ball with the kids. Paint less often. Use Rust-Oleum Wood Saver.
Over its life, a motorcraft battery delivers enough energy to light up a small park. Like Candlestick Park. Shouldn't you install that peace of mind? Motorcraft quality parts from Ford.
It's not easy to pull yourself away from a bowl of Kellogg's Raisin Bran. Those two scoops of raisins taste so good.
Another one of the big stories in the first half of the season in Major League Baseball. And now, the other part of this big story. Ninth inning, 4-2 American League. There's Felix Jose. With that home run that was referred to, and Carlton Fisk is joined by Dennis Eckersley. He's 1-1, 23 saves, tied for the lead in saves in Major League Baseball. And they'll be rooting for him this time in Toronto as he pitches to the National League. And Craig Biggio. We are in the ninth, 4-2 American League. Strike one to Craig.
Real surprise in 38 and a third innings. Eckersley has already walked one this year. He's walked eight players, eight in 2.5 years. Eight.
Eight players in 2.5 years.
4-89, three last year, and one this year.
And Biggio stays up there 0-2. Biggio leading it off, and the National League needs a runner to have a chance. And a foul goes out of play. The on-deck hitter will cause a lot of commotion when he comes up there, George Bell.
George, the MVP here in Toronto in 1987.
We are in the ninth. And Biggio hits it to Alomar, traps it and throws him out. That was a good play on a tough hop. Roberto has played the entire game. And sparkle there.
Fastball away to Biggio, and he hits a rocket to second base, and Alomar taking it right in the stomach and then recovers in time to throw out the speedy Biggio.
Now you talk about mixed reaction. That's what we're getting from the crowd as George Bell comes up to hit. The former Toronto player now playing and producing for the Cubs. Some booing, some standing and applauding. George told us that when he used to play up here, they called him King George. Well, some do, some don't. Leadoff hand is gone. Bell pinch hitting. Batting in the Larkin spot. One out. He knows Eckersley too well. They're having fun with Georgie here.
Yeah, on his return, it doesn't sound to me like he's king for a day.
No. Or for a night here in Toronto. This has been a fun game with a lot of action, and Cal Ripken hoping his three-run homer stands up. That's low. Well, this is Tuesday night. We have baseball for you next Sunday afternoon, 2:30 Eastern Time. Yanks and Angels. Pre-game show. Watch it at 2:30. DiMaggio, Williams. Late swing on that one, 1-2. Oh, they'll howl if he strikes out. They're getting ready.
So is Eckersley.
We'll let you listen. One out, nobody on. National League trailing by 2-9. Two out in the ninth. The coordinating producer of Major League Baseball on CBS is Rick LaCivita. This evening's telecast, directed by Joe Assetti. The producer of Baseball 91 is Mike Arnold. The senior producer of CBS Sports is Ed Gorin. The executive producer of CBS Sports, Ted Shaker. The folks at Dome Productions have really been cooperative and efficient, and our own crew traveling up here to Toronto. And they had everything ship-shape here this evening, and you folks have watched a fun game. Batter Butler, this won't end in a hurry. He'll battle Eckersley, ball one. His first at bat. Into the game as a pinch hitter. Stayed in, played center field, and he gets an at bat. In a foul, they try to slap it past third. Bobby Bonilla drove home the first run of the game in the first inning. Then Ripken with a three-run homer in the American League third. The Dawson homer was gigantic. 3-2 in the fourth. An insurance run in the seventh inning on the sacrifice fly by Baines. That's why we are where we are. Ninth inning. Two out. 4-2 American League. Trying to make it four in a row over the Nationals. Another foul by Brett Butler. Best wishes to Hank Aaron and Rod Carew. They're the honorary captains here tonight. And Rod's headed for the Hall of Fame. Ferguson Jenkins. Gaylord Perry, Tony Lazzari, Bill Beck, Joe Garagiola, Phil Collier. Butler keeps us here. One ball, two strikes. Our folks at Fuji have given us the blimp shots, which we've all enjoyed. Before we close it off, we want to remember Dave Dravecki and admire his courage. Dave Dravecki, our very best to you. And we know you make the strong comeback. Another foul by Butler. What a courageous guy, Tim.
Dave Dravecki had his left arm amputated about 10 days ago. Coming back from surgery, cancer in the left arm, and that remarkable comeback, and then felled by the arm problems once again while pitching in Montreal, pitching for the Giants.
So hello to Dave, and here is a pitch to Butler that might end it. No, another foul out of play. It's still 1-2 with two out in the ninth inning. What do you remember most of all about this one, Tim?
The stadium and the people and the excitement.
And the home run by Ripken and the blast by Dawson. Well, Tony La Russa will win three in a row if it comes to fruition here. First ever to do that as a manager.
Maybe three's the magic number, because if Eckersley saves this game, as you look at the three-run homer by Ripken, if Eckersley saves this game, he will have three All-Star saves, the first man to ever do it. So three's the number right now.
And a good play by Eckersley. The American League wins it. 4-2. It was a lovely evening here in Toronto. Pat O'Brien will be joining us and have some interesting comments for you. Don't go away. The American League won it 4-2 on a wonderful night in Canada.
Over its life, a motorcraft battery delivers enough energy to light up a small park, like Candlestick Park. Shouldn't you install that peace of mind? Motorcraft quality parts from Ford.
Motorcraft energy conserving oil can help reduce fuel consumption. It can also reduce traffic. Motorcraft quality parts. Peace of mind from Ford.
If your sporty car doesn't feel so sporty anymore, you need a change. To BF Goodrich TA tires, put on a set and feel a whole new level of performance.
Introducing a true breakthrough in sun protection. New Sweatproof Copper Tone Sport. When you sweat, it won't run in your eyes to sting you. New Sweatproof Copper Tone Sport. Because for some, life's not a beach.
People can give you their word in many ways. But when it comes to something as important as selling your home, you want a commitment in writing. That's why at Century 21, we give you our Seller Service Pledge. A written commitment that spells out a specific plan of action and promises the highest level of professional service, the standard by which all others will be judged. Century 21, it's as good as done.
Sunday, they're young and very restless. The up-and-coming Yankees take on ex-teammate Dave Winfield and the Angels. Baseball's biggest moments are on CBS.
In the tropics, he's the only private eye.
If you're in trouble, maybe I can help.
And things are heating up. Sweating Bullets in CBS Prime after the flash Friday.
CBS Sports coverage of the 62nd All-Star Game from Toronto has been brought to you by Lexus Automobiles, the result of a relentless pursuit of perfection. AT&T, the right choice. And by Miller Lite, it's it, and that's that.
And so the American League has won now the last four All-Star Games, winning tonight 4-2, and the fans here in Toronto go out into the balmy Ontario air with cautious dreams of the second season. And the man who had a dream night is standing by with Jim Cott. Jim?
All right, Pat, I'm with Kurt Ritter, marketing manager, trucks from Chevrolet, who has a very pleasant duty and a presentation to make. Kurt?
Congratulations, Cal. Splendid performance. On behalf of Chevrolet and all of its dealers, I'd like to present you with the Chevrolet MVP Award. As well, I'd like to present you with a 91 Chevrolet Astro van that will be donated in your name to the charity of your choice. Thank you much for a splendid performance.
Thank you.
Boy, what a couple of nights here. I mean, when you go home tonight with Kelly and you talk about the home run hitting contest, being in this place, what's the thing you're going to take from this game with you most of all?
Geez, I don't know. Probably I surprised myself the last couple of days. I don't know. I haven't done much offensively in any of the games I've played in. Matter of fact, I almost doubled my hit output tonight. And to hit a home run, it was just a great feeling.
And yesterday had to be a thrill, too, because you've said your all-star hero is Brooks Robinson. He was in the game yesterday.
That's so true. I grew up trying to be just like Brooks Robinson. He was here. I did well in the all-star game. Couldn't ask for anything more than that.
Don't need any more days off. No more talks about days off for Cal Ripken Jr., right?
Well, that's the best part about having such a good first half and a good all-star game here is everybody's let the take a day off line die for right now.
Great night. Very enjoyable. Let's go back to Pat O'Brien.
Thank you. He may have surprised himself, but he did not surprise the fans of baseball. We'll be back with a final thought from Ontario after this. Stay with us.
Thank you.
Some men would rather live their lives sheltered in the harbor, and some would rather sail into life with the unmistakable scent of Old Spice. Clean, true, and classic. Old Spice, one of the legends of the sea.
The race is on to make batteries that last longer. And today's Duracell batteries can even outrun the ones we made just a few years ago. Today's Duracell, you can't top the copper top.
No better way to face the day.
The morning belongs to Speedstick. It's what more men reach for, to prepare, to prevent, to protect. Speedstick.
No better way to face the day.
When you've got a tough case of athlete's foot, the itching, the cracking, the burning, you want a medicine that acts tough. Tough Actin Tenactin. Clinically proven Tenactin cures even the tough cases of athlete's foot fungus. Get Tough Actin Tenactin.
This is not what you want in a shave. Now you've got the edge with six rich lubricants for less irritation. You've got the edge.
And so the American League has won the 62nd All-Star Game 4-2 here in Toronto. And you know, over 100 years ago, the great American man of letters, Walt Whitman, bid adieu to Ontario with these words. Goodbye, Toronto, with memories of a very lively and agreeable visit. Indeed. So for Jack Buck, Tim McCarver, Jim Cott, President Bush, and Brian Mulrooney, I'm Pat O'Brien saying so long from SkyDome, where the final score of the 1991 All-Star Game, once again, is 4-2. CBS Sports coverage of Major League Baseball continues this Sunday at 2:30 Eastern Time with Baseball 91, followed by the New York Yankees and the California Angels. On Saturday at 5 Eastern, CBS Sports takes you to the Charlotte Motor Speedway for the Battle of the NASCAR Legends. Been watching the 1991 All-Star Game on CBS Sports, home of the biggest games in baseball, the League Championship Series, and the World Series. So we all look forward to the second half of the season. Till then, good night, everybody.